Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to welcome you to a cold, windy Americus, Georgia, as Francis Marion has traveled from South Carolina to take on our Georgia Southwestern Hurricanes. Francis Marion, leadoff batter. Will Hardee steps in there, left fielder, number five, here with Ryan Young, and this is Scott Westbrook, and we have had some eventful activities.
Everything was going smooth as silk, Scott, and then all of a sudden the good Lord decided to just throw us a good gust of wind, took our tent and took some of our fine
equipment
up here, and
the Lord called
one of them home.
That's exactly right. It took our caller amp home. I think it's we're gonna have to have a funeral for it. Scoreboard mechanism up here is on life support. I'm not gonna sure if it's gonna make it or not. But we have a 1-1 count. We're going to have to keep up with it because we don't have scoreboard to tell us. Hot shot to third base.
Skelton just by Skelton. Little.
Is that E5?
Yeah, we're going to have to give it to him.
All right, since we're the only official scorers up here.
Brian
really is official.
He is the official.
We are unofficial scorers. So that E5. Next up to bat is Cole Hennett, the right fielder for Francis Marion.
And I tell you, Scott, the wind is really, really blowing out the left field. So pop flies will be interesting as we got one right here out to Foster.
Foster fields it. Hardee was almost a second. He was anticipating that one maybe being over his head, but he scampers back to first. One out. Runner still on first.
And Scott, on a remind our viewers and listeners, or update them, the Canes are right in the middle of this. We're playing for something. We're playing for the postseason right
now. That's exactly right.
Late April, buddy.
Some folks midseason may have written us off, but this team has gotten hot and looking to win this series and hopefully put us on into the postseason and put us in the conference tournament. Ball one. Gage Taylor, number 10 center fielder. He is from South Lebanon, Ohio, senior, 5'11", 185 pounds.
I think he's batting mid-threes, 347, I believe. I looked at it. I was in Coach McDonald's office and talked with him and Coach LaMoth. Looked over some of these guys. Top three guys, three or four hitters that Francis Marion has, really hits the ball well.
Poor old Micklig, man. He had everything set up ready to go for this game. We had music playing, strike one. Had the music playing, had the scoreboard ready to go. And then about 15 minutes before game time, I'm going to say it's a tornado. Unofficial tornado. Picked up our tent, picked up the table, and just slung all our equipment all over the concrete. The biscuits in my jar of candy did survive, though. High fly ball. Bo Halcombe. Left field. Fights the win. These outfielders, God bless them right now, you know?
Yeah. So to give you a little left to right, we got Skelton at third, Mamatis at short, Beta at second, Bradley
Huff
at first, and we have Bo Halcombe out in left, Hunter Foster in center, and Jonathan Martin out in right field, and of course, old Steady Eddie behind the plate, Jacob Harrell.
And Tucker Smith.
Tucker Smith's on the mound for us. So I'll tell you what, not that Jacob didn't have enough fans, but he picked up one extra fan just the other night.
How so?
Well, in case our listeners don't know, Harrell is a math whiz.
Oh, look out.
So my daughter needed a little help with Algebra 1. And you having children, you know, it just comes – if you can find some other help.
Get
help.
It.
And Jacob came over, and we were very appreciative of that. And I know my daughter, Tate,
mm-hmm.
will be cheering hard for Jacob Harrell today.
Well, the thing is in our day, we would have known it, but we ain't been in a classroom in 20 years. So it's nice to have, you know, math whiz behind the plate and – eager to help out with some of the youth in our community. Foul ball into the – oh, my goodness, I almost hit the car going right down the street. behind the Hurricane dugout. Miklik has gone to the softball field to try to get a new amp and maybe a scoreboard operator for those that may be here listening to us at the game. Ball. This is Nick Pappas, first baseman. Nick is from Columbia, South Carolina, 6'3", 220-pound junior. Steps in there, two outs, gets a little blooper. Oh, my goodness, falls fair, two-out blooper. So the runner at first was leaving on contact, and he had his wheels strong enough to get into home plate, and Pappas ends up at a stand-up double at second.
I tell you, that just hugged the line down the left field, Scott.
I thought the wind was going to push it foul.
Well, it was kind of low, so it stayed kind of down out of that wind. And, had it been up, for sure, there's no doubt it would have blown foul. But he just reached out there and tapped it over Skelton's head. And
if you can get him to run down that double. That's right. If you can get it to run down that baseline, you know, it's usually extra bases.
So Francis Marion draws first blood here in the top half of the first inning with two outs.
Laniel Gonzalez, number 32, designated hitter, steps in there. Takes strike one. Gonzalez from Sumter, South Carolina. He's 6'2", 230 pounds, Lakewood High School. Tucker Smith gets a sign. Runner at second gets his lead. Delivers ball one. Counts 1-1. Hopefully we can keep up with it for a little while.
It'll keep us on our game. We're going to have to pay a lot better attention.
Well, that's never been one of our strong suits.
No, we like to talk.
Yeah, and get distracted and talk to folks in the stands.
So I thought they were going to call on you to sing the national anthem since we have a little PA problem, Scott.
I was prepared.
Get the crowd singing with us.
I was prepared. I have my own rendition that I do an interpretive dance along with it also that, you know, I may bless the fans in the second game of the doubleheader today with if we don't have our issues repaired by then. I believe Gonzalez got strike two right there. Miklik has ran over to the softball field and scurried back with a new amp. Hopefully we can get things fixed. Foul ball all the way over to behind the apartment complex.
As we always say it, he is probably the hardest working guy in sports.
Man, I'm telling you. He nonstop.
When he gets here, and I mean he's wide open from the time he gets here to the time he leaves.
He's planning two moves ahead. You can tell he's two moves ahead of everybody else all the time. he's doing something and in his mind he's working on the next thing in his head when he's doing something. He didn't jinx it. He's saying he jinxed it. He didn't jinx a thing. We ain't gonna let that kind of pagan thought process work into Easter weekend. I can tell you that.
It's not Mick League's fault the wind's blowing.
No.
Mm-mm. It's not his fault. We don't have a press box.
Foul ball. Look,
we're in hunt of a press box.
Yes, I know. If anybody, you know, I mean, right now. I mean, probably what one of those new amps and scoreboard operators cost, probably could have bought a press box. A
couple of bricks.
That's it. One plumbing fixture.
Yeah.
Off the clearance rack.
Leather chair for me and you.
That's right. Tucker Smith delivers. Gonzalez continues to battle. Francis Marion fans were very helpful when our storm damage occurred.
Absolutely. And stepped right up to the plate.
We appreciate them being there for us and offering their condolences and helping hand to just get our 10th strike three. And that'll do us at the top of the first inning. 1-0 Francis Marion over our Canes on the Surge Sports Network.
beta you.
All right. Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. Bottom of the first, Micklig, Miracle Worker Micklig steps in there and gets us a new amp. We have PA music and announcing. Now we just got to get the scoreboard, and we will be set, ladies and gentlemen.
I think Keith may have – he don't give up much, mm-mm, but I think he may have given up on the scoreboard for the day.
I'm fine. That'll be fine. That's okay. That's okay. Jason Beta steps in there, second baseman to lead off. We got a sidearm pitcher, submariner or something. Evan Flynn, pitcher for the Francis Marion Patriots. Evan Flynn, a 5'10", 175-pound senior. Look at that. See if that wind helps.
No,
it does. Oh, it's over. Beta hits one over the right fielder's head. He's going to stand up at third base for a leadoff triple, ladies and gentlemen.
Atta boy, Beta.
So we have been cussing the wind pregame. We are praising the wind now.
I tell you what, watching the right fielder, he turned left, he turned right, and then he just took off running. I mean, he didn't have a chance to catch that ball. That ball just kept going.
It's a little consolation to their right fielder, but it's going to be tough on these outfielders all day.
And these outfielders may have infield too, for that matter.
That's right.
Pop up in the infield, so you definitely need to be hustling everything out.
We've got a whole new level of difficulty at today's game.
So a great leadoff triple by Skelton. I mean Beta.
Line drive, Beta. Line drive foul down right field. Tyler Skelton steps in there, third baseman.
And Keith Micklig sitting to the left of me, he got excited when he saw that base hit. First, he wanted to see something positive happen today, and there he's got something started already in the bottom of the second. In the first, rather.
Miracle worker Micklig.
Oh, Micklig.
Keith, a lesser man may see that, but we know the truth. Micklig say he's just unplugging and plugging stuff up here, but reality suggests otherwise.
He has no quit in him.
That new amp did not just magically appear on this table. I don't know what the count is, but
I know he's got two strikes on him.
Okay.
I think
come
it's 0-2.
Skelton. Low and away. Tell me about this pitcher there.
What are you sidearm?
That's what I say. I mean, yeah, that's gotta mess our timing up and all that kind of stuff, don't you think?
Well, I tell you, the guy is certainly a different release point what you know you're used to, but you know the Hurricanes, of course, Beta hit from the left side is gonna see it a lot better.
Man.
For the right-handers, it'll be a little bit more of a challenge. But speaking of the devil, we got a left-hander coming up to the plate.
Yep. Jamar, Jonathan Martin, our right fielder, number 20, steps in there.
Batting third, our right fielder, number 20, Jonathan Martin.
You know, I wonder how you know, a kid starts pitching like that, sidearm. I wonder how that all comes to – I've always wondered that, Ryan.
Well, I don't know whether you – I don't know if he was a sidearm pitcher in high school. I know when I played here in college, Coach Haywood, which Haywood pitched in the major league, so he would try things with some guys that –
See, look at there. He comes over him.
He came over the top that time. So.
Right.
But Flynn came into the game today with a 4.82 ERA.
We've seen sidearm, submarine, and now over the hand. I don't know. I wonder if he's a switch pitcher. I wonder if he'll throw one left-handed.
I'm going to tell you, changing the arm angles there.
That's right.
That's
tricky.
Yep.
He's just showing out now. Jamar. Got his timing down on that pitch, drove it to right field, scores a first run for the Canes, makes the score 1-1.
And, Scott, as Southwestern is playing to get in the postseason, Francis Marion also, of course, is playing to get in the postseason. If I looked at it correctly, I think Francis Marion, basically, if they win one of these games this series, they'll clinch to get into the postseason, if I'm not mistaken.
And the Canes got a –
Well, it just depends. I know we had Pembroke that lost two games, they're playing today. Landers lost their first two games. They're playing today. So, you know, we're bunched up right in there with Lander and Pembroke. So, I think the Canes, it's pretty easy. Just win.
Mm-hmm.
Just win.
Just win. That's it. Let them think to get rid of itself.
You got to take one game at a time.
Is he going to have an overhand delivery to left-hand batters and a sidearm to right-handed, you think? With Foster up there, that's what he came in sidearm again.
Mm-hmm.
So I wonder if that's what he's going to do. It's a bold strategy, Cotton. Let's see how it works out for him. So low ball two.
And I think that's Jamar's ninth stolen base on the season.
Catcher came up ready to fire but couldn't get the handle on the ball. So we'll still give him a SB on that one.
So he's 9 for 10 in the stolen base department now.
Chopper to second baseman. Fields it, throws to first for out number two, but Jamar advances to third, so he's standing 90 feet away with two outs. Andy Moore, our designated hitter, steps in there.
And just looking at the stats, Keith pointed out, you know, as far as these two teams, as far as stealing bases, I think we're going to be down at the bottom of the barrel as far as stolen bases go in the conference. I think as a team, Francis Marion's only stole their 23 for 27. So,
I wonder if that sidearm delivery helps you out when you're trying to steal. Because I mean, helps out the base runners. Now look, there's the left-handed
it
batter.
It may be a little slower delivery to the plate, throwing down that low. And I'm gonna tell you what, his knuckles almost grab some dirt when they come through there.
And you know, now we got a left-handed batter up. He came with submarine delivery. I mean, sidearm delivery. Then
I think he's just going to start mixing. I mean, he'll mix it up probably throughout the game.
I mean, I halfway expect him to start throwing knuckleballs in the second inning. Low and away, ball two. I believe that ball two.
Two outs.
Runner at third, 90 feet away. Go ahead, run. Our designated hitter, Andy Moore, steps in there. Former Peach Belt Player of the Week. Wasn't he Peach Belt Player of the Week early in the season?
Yes, he was.
I thought he was.
We probably should have had another one with Jamar last week. Kind of don't understand a little bit of that. He and we probably should have had a freshman player of the week with Mamadas. I mean, yeah, Jamar was 588. We took two out of three from Lander.
Yeah.
And Mamadas, I think, batted 500.
And they gave it to a kid from Lander, didn't they?
Okay, well, the freshman player of the week, they gave it to the kid from Georgia College who got swept. And I do believe they gave it to the left fielder for Lander. But, you know, I don't understand. I mean, maybe I don't understand how you do that. You know, every time I ever watch Super Bowl, I never see them give the MVP to the losing team.
No, no.
But those stats.
I'm just going to label it as Peach Belt politics.
Well, our kid certainly played good and was well, you know, deserving of that. But listen, we'll give that up just to get in the playoffs.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. That's
as long as we keep winning.
That's it right there. Another single. That'll score the go-ahead run. Andy Moore gets all the way to first base. Stops there. Jamar scampers in. It's 2-1. Canes over the Patriots. So the wind has played a role here in the first inning, I think. I think that one that a Beta hit, that triple, you know, the right fielder struggled with that. So I think, you know, on a clear day, he still may have had a hard time with it because it was a deep, long hit ball. But still, it was dancing around in the sky to where
I think it's going to be a factor today. Mm-hmm. There's no doubt. Hopefully the wind to calm down, just let these guys – you let the Southwestern – beat them straight up. I don't want the wind to play a factor unless it's going to help us.
Unless it helps us. I know. Well, it's already claimed two lives here in the press area.
Yes.
It's already claimed the life of our scoreboard machine and strike and one of our amps. So I don't think, you know, I think we've laid our sacrificial lambs on there. It's time for Francis Marion to lose a little bit. And we got hit in the checkbook, which brings us up to our golf ball. We're trying to sell right now, Ryan. A good time for somebody to come and buy a bunch of golf balls, help us replace some of the stuff. Strike three, but not before the Canes get two runs. Go ahead, 2-1. We go to the top of the second on the Surge Sports Network. We welcome everybody back. Top of the second inning for Francis Marion up to bat on the dangerous side of the inning. I want to thank one of our listeners for letting us know that Ryan's mic was a little bit low, and so we bumped it on up there. And so hopefully we'll be able to hear Ryan's mic. High fly ball. Jamar unaffected by the wind for out number one.
I want to thank McCracken for that.
That's exactly right.
I'll tell you what, Scott, I want to give you a little bit of a thanks and farm credit. I'm going to tell you, you invited me to eat lunch with y'all the other day and enjoyed seeing a lot of the customers y'all have, and I know they were appreciated it, but my gosh, it was a fine meal.
I know. That seafood company, I think they're out of Bainbridge. It comes up here, and it's a second generation. It's a guy, his dad did it. Now this man has got it. He goes around, he cooks all kinds of fresh seafood on site for weddings and get-togethers, and then now he's teaching his son to do it. So it must be a pretty good business.
And it was fantastic, and I appreciate the invite. And Farm Credit's been good to Georgia Southwestern out here, letting you come do some of these things and do a lot in our community. Well, we appreciate your company doing those things.
Well, I do. They actually encourage it, but they don't have to encourage me. I mean, you know, I just enjoy getting plugged in the community and doing whatever I can. And
I think McCracken just woke up from his nap after that lunch.
I'm
I
surprised.
Saw how much he ate.
Well, I'm about to say, if you're behind him in line, I hope you were ahead of him.
I got some leftovers from him.
High fly ball.
Beta gets under it and makes the play for the second out for the Hurricanes.
We are taking little young Cole up under our wing, trying to help him out with some of the music selection here for those of you fans that are here today. So you may hear some little bit different music coming from the PA today. So sit back and enjoy.
They won't.
Who's that?
They won't.
Oh, well, people on the don't. But there's some people here listening to us right now. There's people here in this almost sold out crowd.
I need to point out too, because you're probably going to do a little dance and try to warm up. Scott, unbeknownst to, he did not obviously check the weather. There's a fly ball hit out to Hunter Foster. He's under it, and I'll tell you a little bit about that when we get back about what Scott's wardrobe looks like today, folks. It is not for these conditions. I will tell you that. But we go to the bottom of the second inning. You're listening to the Surge Sports Network. 2-1.
Inning for the Hurricanes, first baseman number 10,
Bradley Huff. All right, Bradley Huff steps up for the Hurricanes as Scott is trying to – Scott's looking for music for our DJ over here, old Cole, trying to get him up to speed. I know Thurston did check in with us saying my mic was a little down, so I hope you can hear me now. Thurston, let us know how it's doing. As Huff fouls one off back here toward the press box. Swung on and missed for strike two. So I was telling you about my friend Scott Westbrook here, and he don't have his headset on, so I need to go ahead and get him so he don't have a chance to get back at me here. But Scott came very I tell you, he's not a selfish guy. He's looking out for everybody else. He's brought biscuits. He's brought candy. I mean, he just does everything for everybody else. It didn't look out for himself. I don't know what his wife was thinking letting him walk out of the house today with shorts and a T-shirt. And he's paying the price for it. So if he starts talking very fast, or rather probably slows down a little bit, it's because he's freezing to death here. So somebody needs to bring this man some clothes. So Huff's worked the count 2-2. A 2-2 pitch on the way. Missed low and inside for ball three.
Ryan, I almost drove my little Suzuki Samurai here today, but I said, no, it's probably too cold for that. So I did come in this, but I had no idea that here at GSW, we are right in the jet stream, hot shot ground ball up to the center fielder for a single for Bradley Huff as he stands at first base.
Well, you may should have driven it, and you'd have turned right back around right quick and got you some clothes.
That's right. Usually my extra layer of skin and my high blood pressure keeps me warm in most places, but it's not working today.
Well, look, I will snuggle with you, Scott.
Thank you.
I'm a snuggler.
I appreciate that, and I appreciate the offer.
For the shortstop, number 7, Matthew Mamatis.
So Mamatis comes up to the plate swinging a hot bat. Had a good series against Lander, as I mentioned before. I think he batted 500 in that series as he swings and drives one foul down the left field line. I think Mamatis had a couple of hits against Valdosta as well during the midweek. The Canes did beat Valdosta 12-2 early on this week. And the Hurricanes have been playing really, really good ball. I've been so proud, and it's so much fun to watch these guys play. But they have turned it on here as of late. As Mamatis watches a ball up.
What's an AC/DC song that comes? This starts off hot. Maybe if Thurston's in the still listening to us, he can text me one. Because some of theirs start off so slow, and if I come out of the gates with a slow AC/DC song, these boys are going to give us crap between games.
Shoot the thrill, but I don't think it comes out real hot.
Yeah, because I mean I know like Thunderstruck, it comes out real slow. I think it builds up pretty good, but I don't know. I'm trying to think. Here, I'll give him pass those down there to get him started right there. We'll get him going with those. Runner at first. Bottom of the second. Fly ball.
Scott, we don't have our protected shell around us as the wind has just almost destroyed our tent earlier today. So
from that unrecorded tornado that I know
I do have a hard hat in the truck I may go get.
Okay. I believe the weather service may not recognize that tornado, but we saw the effects of it here.
So Mamatis worked the count to 2-2.
Bradley Huff at first with nobody out.
Nobody out. I know you've been busy with your head down in there trying to get Cole going over here.
And I tell Cole is this. I said, look, when the opposing team, when the pitcher is warming up, they made a pitching change, you got to throw some water on them. You got to come in with dueling banjos, something that's going to cool. You don't want to sit there and play some upbeat rap music that's going to fire that pitcher up. You got to throw a little water on him.
Cole's starting to learn a little bit. It's taken almost a whole season, but we finally get him to come around.
That's right.
To being here, Scott. He's starting to listen.
If we can just get him to cut that hair.
So Mamatis fights it off, fouls it off down the line to right, so it's a full count. I think Cole's mind's made up, Scott. He's not cutting his hair.
Okay, well, that's all right. That's the heel he chooses to die on. That's his choice. We get him some good music, and he'll take care of himself. If we're going to sit there and funnel him some 80s music, he's got to get him an 80s haircut. Ball four. We got runners at first and second. Wind gust up yet again. We put one up there in the stratosphere. Let's see what happens.
And I hope it couldn't happen to anybody better than Jacob Harrell.
That's right, Jacob Harrell.
I do like his walk-up song.
He does, yeah, that's it.
Nobody out for the catch. pitcher, number 24, Jacob Harrell.
And Jacob Harrell's mom and dad is at the game today. I see him down there. I got to go speak to him.
He's squaring the bunt with nobody out, runners at first and second. Oh, he's hit by the pitch. He got hit by the pitch. Oh, so he said, what's it?
I don't think he ever pulled the bat back. That's what the umpire's saying. I don't know. Here comes Coach McDonald to maybe get an explanation from that. But I'm not sure if he pulled the bat back or not. Of course, the umpire did not see that. So that's why he called it a foul ball.
Can we get our instant replay ready in case they ask for it?
Well, I'm sure. I don't know. Coach McDonald's going to have a conversation with the home plate umpire here and may ask for help out in the outfield.
I think this is probably – that was probably a friendly conversation. I think that was friendly conversation.
So the umpires will get together here and make a decision here, talk it over.
You know, one thing
– he's probably saying – I'm sorry, Scott, go ahead.
No, they never ask our opinion.
Never.
Never, you know, appeal to us up here.
So that call is going to stand.
Strike?
It's got to be.
Uh-huh. Jacob Harrell. Steps in there, 0-1, runners at first and second, nobody out. Infielder's in, anticipating another bunt, it looks like. But he hadn't squared the bunt. Now he has. Sidearm hit, great bunt
by Harrell.
Harrell, dig, brother. Still, does his job, sacrifices.
He does it all the time. I mean, and you know, Harrell, a leader on this team, I'm telling you, that kid, he's just –
always smiling when we go down there and see him before the game.
Always. And if you see him, how many catchers you ever see sprint out to the plate? You watch Harrell, when he comes back on this field, he's giving it all he's got. He gives it all he's got every single game.
Jason Beta steps in there with 1-1 with a leadoff triple.
Like to see him duplicate that. Or one up himself right here.
That's exactly right. Low and a bit outside. I believe the wind caught that one.
But I tell you, hey, really, Harrell did a heck of a job. So he's going to be a teacher. So, you know, he got his first test with my daughter. So he still says he still wants to be a teacher. So that's good.
That's awesome. I anticipate him being a coach also, I would think.
That's what he said. He said he wants to teach math and coach. I think he'll make a good one.
Ball two. 2-0. Yeah, he shouldn't have a hard time finding a job. I tell you, math teachers / coaches are in high demand right now. It's tough to fill a lot of math teaching slots.
Well, he's going to make a vacancies. Good one. Whoever gets him.
Maybe we can keep him local. Find one of these schools around here, whether it be.
Who knows? It'd be interesting, you know. Some of these players on this team may want to come back and be a grad assistant if we have that available for them. Mm-hmm. Get their master's degree and help coach these Hurricanes.
And catchers usually do end up making some of the best coaches. I mean, that's
– Look around the league. Look around the major leagues.
2-1.
I believe wasn't Bobby Cox a catcher? Was he a catcher? I can't remember. I know –
Did they have catchers then? I think that's when they played with 8 players back then. I think the batter was responsible for retrieving his own ball when Bobby Cox played.
Kind of like centers in the football. Make great offensive line coaches, coordinators.
Oh, I thought you were going to say like centers in basketball, that they don't have those anymore. That has a position that's kind of fallen by the wayside. High foul ball out of play.
And the wind is still just hurling out here. I mean, it's – What do you think is blowing? 30 miles an hour?
Yeah, I think wind chill factor for me is around 30 right now, too. So, yeah, it's. I hope my lovely daughter gets here with my wind shirt before too long.
They're taking their time. I think. Are they trying to teach you a lesson or what?
Yeah, I think that hopefully they may be tuning in, listen to us, and hear the agony in my voice.
Right off the end of his bat. That's a hit. That's going to get out. It stayed in fair territory. Got the run home.
Sure did. I tell you what, he almost ran past that pitcher. That's it. That's So, yeah, scored one unassisted tagged out, but we got RBI on that one, so we're at 3-1.
I mean, I guess he hit it right off the end of the bat, it sounded like. Or on his hands, I couldn't tell.
It looked like one of those practice balls you use that are filled with sand. You hit it as hard as you can, but it's only going to go about, you know, 30, 40 feet.
And nevertheless, hey, look, good job by Harrell getting the runners over. That's what happens all you got to do is put the ball in play like that. Good things happen.
Tyler Skelton steps in there. Inside
Keith's over here asking for a pass ball.
It's got to be tough on a catcher trying to catch his sidearm delivery. You know, if you're used to seeing overhand, ball's got a little bit odd movement on it when it's rising on you.
Well, it's going to tail in more than anything throwing with that arm angle. Skelton struck out his first at bat. Maybe he can redeem himself right here with this at bat with a runner on third.
We had a little pregame conversation. I believe Skelton was the one that was least enthusiastic about seeing a sidearm pitcher coming in. Wasn't he?
He's the one. He didn't know that they were going to face the sidearm guy. He's ready now, though.
Oh, yeah.
Tell you and I have gotten to know a lot of these guys, and it's fun to go down before the game, talk to them. And you can tell these guys come to the park to have fun, man.
They do. There's a, you know, just the atmosphere down there. I wish some of the fans could get down there with guys before the game. I mean, they're having a good time.
Oh, man. You can tell they're coming ready to play some baseball.
Ball four. Runners at first and third. Francis Marion fans didn't like that call too much. We got a visiting from the pitcher and coach. Is he making a change?
So as the coach walks out, we'll take a short break. We'll be right back. You're listening to the Surge Sports Network.
Jonathan Martin. Right fielder Jonathan Martin steps in there after that brief visit. Got runners at first and third, two outs. Martin, what, he got a single last time, stole a base?
I think that's right. Mm-hmm. You're starting to ask a lot of me, Scott.
I know. I'm sorry. I hate to put you on the spot like that. When I ask you that, I'm really saying what I think is in my brain.
You just want some.
You
say it. You said it with almost enough conviction to have.
And then I can't remember what happened to him. We got to get a staff, man. We need people handing this stuff in front of us because they expect a lot out of us to remember all this.
You want us to send out some applications? See, you know, just me and you. We'll have a sit down with them. See,
I believe we could probably get some intern, some high school intern, that would maybe have a desire to one day rise to our level and
a lot of pressure there.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, kind of like a Padawan learner, a young Jedi.
That's right.
You know, that we would take under our wing and, you know, I got a fence that needs painting, some cars need waxing. We'll start them off at that level.
I guess they can learn karate.
That's right.
You know, we're playing two games today, and unfortunately Josh didn't want to have to do it, but the weather dictated that. They're playing a game on Easter Sunday, but Josh reached out to some folks in town. They will at 9:15, they got a little devotional they're going to do on Easter morning. I think they're going to do it right down here on the field. Johnny Updike from First United Methodist Church is going to come over here and do a devotional for these guys right here on the field. I think that's going to be pretty cool.
Is Johnny going to bring the snake with him?
I don't know what kind of snake Johnny may bring.
I've always heard the Methodist Church, one of the few churches in the county, that has a coral snake. I've always been real impressed with that.
It's very tame, though. Okay. Very tame.
Very docile.
It's very docile.
I think that would really get the boys' attention if he brought the coral snake out here with him and delivered his message holding that.
They would probably rather come to, miss the game and come watch Johnny handle all that stuff.
Mm-hmm. Another walk. We got the bases loaded, two outs. Bottom of the second, our cleanup man, Hunter Foster, center fielder, steps up to the plate.
So we got two outs and the bases loaded. Kane's on the pond, baby.
For the center fielder, Hunter Foster.
Swing and a miss. Evan Flynn delivers.
Hunter Foster, typically delivers in these situations. He thrives in these situations right here, Scott.
Swing and a miss, 0-2. I'm going to just share this with you. Normally, I always wear a white T-shirt. Even if I wear a regular T-shirt, I wear a white T-shirt under it. I didn't do that today.
That didn't surprise me at all. I mean,
making this just
adding
the misery level.
You were just so excited to get out here.
I was chomping at the bit. I ain't gonna lie to
you.
You're lucky I came out here with any clothes on at all.
Thank you for doing that, though. At least you did put some clothes on.
Yeah. I mean, I was ready to get out here. I'm excited about this weekend series and what it means to our Hurricanes. And I know they were equally as excited.
They got more clothes on than you do, though.
Swing and a miss, strike three. Leave three runners on base. We go to the bottom of the third inning.
Go to the top.
Top of third inning. I'm sorry, top of the third on the Surge Sport Network.
I was halfway right. Did you see that triple play I sent you?
Yes, yes.
One run
I shared
for
it on
the
Facebook.
Hurricanes in the home half of the second inning. We'll head to the third. Your line score after two innings of play, Francis Marion, one run, one hit, no errors, GSW, three runs. Four hits, one error. Don't forget live stats are available, so if you'd like to keep track of the pitches, strikes, outs, all that good stuff, just go to our website, gswcanes.com, gswcanes.com. Calendar in the top right corner if you're on a mobile device.
There's another one in there.
Those links are also available on the Francis Marion website. Athletics webpage, as well as the Peach Belt Conference.
Pass that down there. Pass it down. See if they want one of them.
Hey, here, we better do this. Hey, son, you want some candy? You want me to give you a light down?
Brian, Vic. Brian. Hey, Brian, how about we
due
got a new Louisiana? I invited him to church. He said he said he can't. They know that's what it
happened.
Top of the third inning. Number nine, third baseman Fred Wadsworth, number nine batter, steps in there, hits a high fly ball. Jamar, wind steals for him.
And Scott, you were talking, you had an opportunity to meet our new women's basketball coach.
That's right. Great guy, super guy. He was walking into Two Dukes the other day, and I recognized him. I'm sure everybody listened has seen. When he was hired, I have never seen such a positive response from social media on a hire. I mean, I'm talking congratulations from all over the world. I mean, it was just crazy. I mean, other coaches throughout the country at JUCOs. I mean, obviously this. I was going to say young man just because he's younger than me, but he is very well connected, very well thought of. Justin Payne, I told him, I recognized him going into Two Dukes, and I said, Justin, I said, if I call you Jason, you're just going to have to ignore it because my first roommate in college was Jason Payne. And I said, so just realize if I call you that, you're going to have to remind me your name is Justin. But him and his lovely wife and his son, they were a
good-looking family.
Really are. They I invited him to church. High fly ball to center field.
Foster under it. makes a grab for out number two.
But he said he and his wife are Catholic and looking for, if there's a Catholic church in our community that's looking for some new members, they may want to pay him a visit.
Right there on Lee Street, there's one.
Two outs for the right fielder, Cole Hennett.
So Tucker Smith gave up one run. I believe that was an unearned run, though, if I'm not mistaken.
It was.
But has settled in quite nicely here in the top of the third inning.
Letting his defense do the work for him, man, I tell you.
He's fun to watch.
He is. If I could buy stock in Tucker Smith.
I'd load up on him.
Mm-hmm.
I see Harrison Timberlake's dad's here at the game. We got Miss Mamatis down there. Mr. Mamatis may be listening in.
Jonathan Martin's parents here, aren't they?
Yeah, I see a lot of parents here. We had to tell good pitch here by Tucker. You know that game we won in extra innings that you weren't here? You were doing the play, your Easter play.
Easter play.
I told Mr. Mamatis after the game we dedicated that game to him. How about that?
That'll be fine. That'll work. That's perfect.
So he's one for one.
Mm-hmm.
I would assume they got a come out. Or actually one for two, I guess.
Okay.
We burned him up on one of them, I believe.
Mm-hmm. I think so. Did Brian get him a piece of candy? Because the wind caught that last one you threw down there.
He got up and got it.
You got your candy, Brian? Not yet. Okay, all right. He's paying attention. He's got to do it between innings. High fly ball. Halcombe on his horse, gets under it, catches out number three. So three up, three down.
Another quick inning for the Canes.
We go to the top of the fourth inning.
The bottom of the third.
Bottom of the third, man, I'm messing up. Okay, I'm going to let you do that for now. On the Surge Sports Network.
Down for the Patriots in the third.
Home team.
Third.
I know, I'm just messing up. I know. I know. Let's see how many we got.
We had 23 earlier.
Oh, man.
Two up for the Hurricanes in the third. It'll be Moore, Helcom, and Huff.
You're not a fan?
5, 6, and 7 in the GSW batting order.
He's not a fan.
Who?
Brian.
You don't like it, man? You don't like coffee? Yes, coffee. You don't like it? Man.
Mickley.
I'm sorry, buddy. It's pretty good to me, though. It's 35 calories each, though, man. You don't like coffee? Okay, well, I should have warned you.
Who the hell looks at the calories on candy?
I do.
Do you?
I do, yep.
Yep, that's good, it's good. How much one of them jars like that there cost?
$9.
That's good candy. I'll go turn off. Look, Mickley's still working hard. Cole, that don't sound like anything Scott Webber.
I know it.
What about that song Dynamite? You know that Dynamite song? That's a good one. Put it on my list too, Dynamite.
It ain't gonna do any good.
Cole ain't gonna play nothing. Oh, I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Cole down there playing that same old boring music. For our fans here, and we're trying to get him to play something good. He's working on the scoreboard. He is reading the owner's manual from the scoreboard.
He sure is. He has got his nose right in. As Andy Moore's hit by the pitch and a take first base. So we got a runner on, leadoff hitter on, Scott.
Second batter hit by pitch. First one awarded the base. Moore leans off. Flynn gets ready to deliver. Bo Halcombe.
So we
takes ball one. Our left fielder. Go ahead. I'm sorry. What now?
Well, I was going to let our watchers know that we're trying to get our scoreboard working, and Keith had to reset the scoreboard. In doing so, it's going to reset the center field camera. So momentarily it will be down, and Keith will get out there and take care of it for us.
I don't want to say that we have divine favor today, but look where the wind's blowing now.
Straight out.
I mean, it's been blowing to left field all day, and the Hurricanes come up to bat. We're right in the meat of our order, and the wind shifts, and that flag is going straight out to center field. I believe the umpire is going to go up there and break up his tea party for too long. I just got hit by a pitch in the back of my back. Did you notice that? After that brief visit, or I should say prolonged visit, Bo Halcombe steps in there, a runner on first, nobody out. Hits a line,
that's a
little blooper.
Hit.
Yeah, a blooper right behind the second baseman. That'll get the runners at first and second. Bradley Huff steps in there, no outs. Runners at first and second. We're going to have a visit from the coach to the pitcher on that one after. I want to make a change. We're going to make a pitching change, and we're going to take a break here on the Surge Sports Network. Hey, we got a pitching. Dueling banjos.
All I'm here. Hey, all I'm here is excuse.
That's it.
If he comes in here and shuts us down, it's on you. Yeah. Because you done played some pump up music. Yeah, let me give him some pitching change. When their pitchers are warming up, I'll give you a list of that. This next one, I put a star by. Next time I make a pitching change, I want you to play this. We'll see what happens.
What's his name? Give me his name.
Rogers.
We got a pitching change here for the Francis Marion Patriots. Number 48, Weston Rogers, left-handed pitcher, sophomore, 6'2", 165 pounds from Mullins, South Carolina, steps in there and inherits.
He comes into the game, Scott, with an ERA of 3.94. He's got three wins and three losses on the season.
Bradley Huff fouls, squares the bunt and fouls away the first pitch from Mr. Rogers.
And Rogers, ironically, wears number 48. He has pitched 48 innings thus far this season.
Very astute for you to pick up on that.
Boy,
right?
I'm just good.
Rogers gets ready to deliver. Huff squares to bunt yet again. That bounced off Huff in the batter's box. umpire yells like his hair's on fire, which is good. That's what you want an umpire to do.
That's right. So I think we do have the center field camera back up and running, thanks to Keith Micklig's quick work.
The miracle worker.
The miracle worker, Micklig.
Not only is he a miracle worker, he's humble about it too, Ryan.
Keith's a humble person. Now as soon as he sat down, he's trying to go right to the scoreboard.
Him and Cole down there trying to breathe life into that scoreboard machine, whatever you call it. Hot
he
shot
didn't want
line.
A bunt.
Yes, no, sir. Might have should have taken that bunt. Line drive to right field. Oh, that's going to go in the dugout.
Yes, sir.
That's going to go in the dugout, and all the runners will advance. So after trying to bunt twice.
Can't get the bunt down, and look, go ahead. We got two strikes, so Josh lets him swing away, and, boy, Josh looked real smart on letting him go ahead and swing the bat right
That's
there.
Exactly right.
So, the Canes lead 4-1, I believe, the score.
And the throw was missed by the cutoff man. It rolled all the way into the Canes dugout. Gave the runners, let them all advance one base, scored a run. And we got runners at second and third, nobody out, with Matthew Mamatis.
And I think Mamatis, did he walk his last at bat, Scott?
See, you put me on the spot. I have no idea.
You don't remember?
I don't. With our staff, we've got to get an intern. Got to get an intern.
Did he walk his last at bat, Keith? Do you remember?
So
he did walk his last at bat.
So you were right. Foul ball into the Patriot dugout.
I bet I know who knows.
Who?
Mr. Mamatis.
Well, that, and not only that, Brian knows down there. Brian.
He's way down there, though.
But we gave Brian some of our good new candy we got down here, and Brian did not like it. So we don't have to worry about sharing any more candy with Mr. Brian because he is not a coffee lover.
And I think the candy's great.
I have given Cole a separate list of songs when they make a pitching change to warm up. One of them being the Auctioneer song by Leroy Van Dyke, I think is the guy. It's a song from about the, I don't know, 60s, 50s, 60s, somewhere around there.
Cole looks real excited.
He does. He does. He'll probably get
right. That a boy, Mamatis.
Mamatis hits a worm burner out to left field.
He is really hitting the ball well. Seeing it well, hitting it well.
Gets another RBI, makes the score 5-1.
5-1.
Runners at first and third, nobody out. Jacob Harrell. No, is that it?
Yeah, that's Harrell.
Gerald, Jacob Harrell. Yeah.
Nobody out. Catcher Jacob Harrell. Desperado. Sitting in a old money
collar. A man is on his hollow. Take it easy.
So Harrell sacrificed bunt, his last plate appearance.
Good bunt. Pickoff attempt to first base.
I'd like to see Harrell hit it right in between the center fielder and the right fielder, right in that gap.
Where the Titanic sign is.
Harrell squared around the bunt. So I don't know if there's a little safety squeeze or something was on.
I don't know. Catcher came out looking like he's ready to fire at third. That sun felt good while it was out. I feel like a snake on a rock out here right now. Trying to absorb all the sunlight I can.
So a totally different look for the Hurricanes as the lefty's out on the mound, of course.
Foul. Bunted foul.
So the count's 1-2 to Harrell.
He's going to have to swing away now. Runners at first and third, nobody out. Harrell at the plate with a 1-2 count. Rogers delivers. Ground ball to second. Only one play to first for out number one.
So let's look at this, Scott. We tried to lay down two bunts, tried to move the runners. Who was it, Halcombe?
Mm-hmm. No, it was Huff.
Huff. Huff. Huff. Yeah. Couldn't get the bunt down. two-strike swing, score a run. Harrell couldn't get the bunt down. But, and then now he grounds out to second base, gets a runner in, moves the runner over to second. So I tell you what, we're not executing quite the way Coach McDonald wanted to, but it's working out for us.
I'm surprised the second baseman didn't try to turn that one.
Well, it was hit slow and way to his left. I mean, he was playing probably, you know, way in the hole there. So,
High foul ball out past the swimming pool. Jason Beta.
So, nevertheless, Harrell did his job.
He did.
Just not quite the way Coach McDonald wanted him to. But that's okay.
Runners advanced. Run scored. 6-1.
So low Beta away. Now he turns around and hits from the right-hand side of the plate.
Foul ball straight back in the screen.
So Beta's only hit, he's only had 24 at-bats from the right-hand side of the plate this year. We just don't see that much left-handed pitching. We hadn't this year.
Mm-mm.
But he is only batting 167 from the right-hand side of the plate.
Rogers delivers.
Blow wind.
Fly.
Blow wind.
Ball. Wind.
Blow
and
wind.
They have it, and it is gone, ladies and gentlemen. A wind-assisted home run. We'll take it by Jason Beta. Two-run dinger. He got up in that wind, and the wind just kept kissing it and kissing it and kissing it till it went right out over the left field fence out there near the Bozoff sign.
Yeah.
Makes the score 8-1.
GSW home run by Jason Beta.
And look, Beta just put a good swing on that ball, but I mean, you know, hey, we'll take everything we can get, buddy. And in my book, hey, it looked like he almost hit that house down there.
It did. And Canes fans that are here in the game, take your ticket stub to Burger King tomorrow with Beta's home run and get a Whopper value meal at regular price. Tell Jason Beta thank you when you see him around campus.
There you go.
For your Whopper value meal at a regular price.
So the Canes off to a fantastic start, Scott.
And this pitching change has worked out well for the Canes as much as, I mean, obviously I want the Canes to do well, but I did give Cole kind of a hard time. So if this pitcher comes in here and shuts us down, it's on you because he didn't play a song for my list. Well, Cole gets a stay of execution.
Cole's getting a little coaching over here on the computer, on the DJ machine over here from Brooks. Can you give him a little bit? Look, just encourage him to play our music. That's all we want.
We got a good crowd here today.
Boy,
for
Skelton
hits a hot shot right up the middle. Takes a little funny hop out there at second base. Scampers into center field, but gets him a single. Jamar steps in there. One out. We got one out. Is that one out? I don't know. One out. Good. Yeah, he confirms it.
I'm up here dancing.
No, I know. It's dance party.
Jamar
USA.
From Irwin County. He's his walk-up song is he's thugging through his rainy days. And
is that some Irwin County original?
Apparently. I mean, not original, but it may have caught on maybe in the 2000s. I don't know.
You know, I saw that one of our girls' tennis players from Irwin County did well.
Yeah, I mean,
got a scholar athlete award this week. I forget her name. I saw it on the GSW Athletics, and I noticed, and I was going to ask you about her.
I met her mother. I don't. She knows who I am, of course.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
and that goes without saying.
Yeah, but I did not. I was
knows of you.
Yeah. You know, I've been gone from Irwin County since '95, so it's hard for me to remember everybody. But I did have an opportunity to meet her, and I can't remember her name.
Well, I want to look it up maybe between ends, but I tell you, I looked at her, and Irwin County girls won the state championship in tennis the same time the Taylor County boys did when my son was on the senior on the Taylor County boys tennis team that won the state championship. And I noticed that she was, well, on Facebook, she has my son as a mutual friend, so I'm going to have to find out how they've met through some sort of tennis circles or whatever, but
yeah, both of my nieces are still playing tennis for Irwin County.
They've won how many state championships in the past 5 years? I mean, it's off the chain. I mean, Irwin County's always in there.
My old college roommate who played here, a baseball alumni, Luke Roberts, was the coach for the tennis team. He had just stepped down as the tennis girls coach. His son, Eli, is starting to get starting to play baseball, and Luke wanted to have the opportunity to be able to watch him play as much as he could. John Tuggle is the coach over at Irwin County now.
Girls tennis or girls? He coaches girls and boys?
I believe he's doing both, yeah.
Okay. All right. And that's not uncommon for single-A high schools, but I know Irwin County, always in the girls, because I still follow, you know, high school, especially single-A public tennis, just to see.
In Butler, you know, we got, as Jamar takes ball four.
Walt runners at first and second, one
so
out.
So there is a connection. You know, I know you used to live in Butler, and Trey Carter, I know you know who that is.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
So my neighbor, Philip Roberts, played with Trey Carter at Georgia. They won a couple of national championships up there at Georgia together. You talk about a good tennis team now. Georgia had some back then.
I'm going to tell you a story about Trey Carter. Of course, his father is in the Georgia Sports Hall of Fame, one of the winningest basketball coaches, if not the winningest basketball coach in the state of Georgia, Norman Carter, and former superintendent of Taylor County Schools. But when we got ready to raise money for our boys, when they won the state championship in tennis in 2015, lady in my office, her son also.
Attaboy! Attaboy.
Hunter Foster. I had to look to see when running down the line who was at bat. He hit a hot shot to second baseman, a little too hot for him to handle. We got runners, we got bases loaded right now with just one out. And our Andy Moore, one of our power hitters, stepping up to bat with the wind swirling yet again. But the lady that worked in my office, she put in there about a fundraiser that we were having to raise money for the boys' tennis team because Taylor County had never won a state championship in tennis before. And so Trey Carter reached out to her and said, how many rings do y'all need to buy? And she said how many rings we were planning on buying for the coaches and the players. And he said, well, what's the total amount? And she relayed it to him. He stroked a check for every one of them.
Way to give back. I mean, Trey, you know, it's been a long time since I've seen him. I used to go up and watch Philip play tennis up there. And, and all those guys, they were very good. You know what the most interesting thing to watch when I'd go up there? It wasn't the tennis matches.
The fans.
Well, they when you watch those guys string rackets, they have contests. And it was crazy.
Really?
How they would do it.
Yummer. Lunch has arrived. Look at there.
They surprised me with lunch.
They did.
Look, we got some more candy up here.
Awesome. Oh, man, yeah, that's some Easter candy right there.
But, Scott, they could – and Michael Permforce was on that team. Mm-hmm. And they could flat out string those rackets. I mean, I can't remember. It was in just a few minutes they could string a racket.
Our boys continued to raise the money they had raised, and they continued to raise money, and they bought Trey a ring. They were able to buy him a ring. So that was their – thank you they sent to him.
Isn't the facility named after him up there?
Norman Carter's gym, is the gym is named after him and Coach Troutman. When you say tennis facility, I use that term loosely because when Taylor County won the state championship in tennis, there were only two tennis courts on campus. So they had the girls and boys, both varsity teams, had to practice on two tennis courts. I'm not talking two, like, facilities with several courts. I'm talking one court, two court.
Wow.
That's all they had.
Wow.
So it wasn't really much of a facility, but since then they've added some courts out of the rec department.
Well, it's real nice because I was up there last year when my nieces were playing, and mm-hmm. I thought I saw where they had maybe – they may call it the Trey Carter.
Maybe they – I mean, more fitting person that should be named after. High fly ball to center field. Out number three. So how many runs? What do we got, Keith? Come in and score. 8-1 on the Surge Sports Network as we go to the top of the next inning.
So Tucker Smith gets ready to go to work. As the Hurricanes are leading 8-1.
Number 10, Gage Taylor, fouls off the first pitch from Tucker Smith in the top of whatever inning we're at.
I'm fixing to do us a solid, Scott.
Please. Because without a scoreboard, man, I'm telling you, I'm handicapped on here anyway, but you give me don't give me a scoreboard. I'm struggling.
We're in the top of the fourth inning.
Top of the fourth inning. Really? No. I would think fifth inning by now.
Well, you know, I'm looking at the live stats.
Okay, well.
So if that's wrong, it's Brian's fault. And I'm trusting in Brian.
I would trust in Brian, too. Brian's far more accurate in many things. But, Brian, let me tell you this. Fans at home, if you're looking for a Christmas present, you're going to get Brian. Make sure it's not coffee related. Because Brian is not a fan of coffee. Brian has a new ally on the sports hall, being another native Louisianian.
Glad to have him, too. And, you know, though, Brian hates coffee, and Mick Ligg
has a coffee drip.
Oh, yeah,
he puts in his veins, straight to his veins. He has an IV coffee drip. Taylor, the center fielder, facing Smith, hits a
good piece of hitting right there.
That was ground ball right in between our shortstop and third baseman.
If I'm a betting man, Tucker may have missed his spot just a little bit right there, but it's still a good pitch, good hit.
Bo Halcombe fielded it cleanly, fired it back in, held the runner at first base. Nick Pappas, is it Pappas or I don't know
how? Pappas.
Pappas, okay, uh-huh. Nick Pappas. Stands in there. We're in number 42.
Pappas?
Pappas, thank you. Okay, Pappas. I apologize if he has family members. Yeah, I can barely read, so y'all just bear with me.
And Keith pointing to this page, you know.
Plays the first baseman, Nick Pappas.
Me reading it off that page ain't going to help me enunciate it any better.
No, we – Lord help us.
Where? Yep, I see that now. So I apologize to Keith.
Almost. Oh, my goodness. Jason Beta. How about Jamar coming in firing, trying to get him a second?
Hustling in right behind Beta.
That was a heck of a play by Beta.
Almost had the runner caught up in no man's land right there.
That's right,
you know?
He sure did.
So good hustle on for Francis Marion and the Hurricanes.
That's Gage Taylor that slid in there and made it to second. He was in a precarious position there between first and second, not knowing if Beta was going to catch it. And then when it dropped, Jamar was on his horse backing him up and almost got him out at second regardless. But no outs, runners at first and second. Tucker Smith faces Lineal Gonzalez. I think I hear one of their fans call him Lenny, so I think I'll call him Lenny from here on out.
You can't go wrong. You know.
Lenny Gonzalez. I'll tell you one thing. These Francis Marion fans, about 10 rungs higher than the Lander fans, in my opinion. I can tell you that.
Easy
right
now.
I'm going to go ahead and say it. I mean, they have been nothing but polite. They helped us when we had our storm damage earlier before the game, and they have really been top shelf here in the stands.
Scott, you got big Easter plans as far as your lunch goes?
Let me tell you what we're doing tomorrow. Okay, I'm teaching Sunday school tomorrow, one thing. I'm one of the greeters. I hope my daughter remembered to bring my seersucker suit back from Butler. It was in the closet up in Butler, so I hope she remembered to bring it back. So I'll have my seersucker suit on, my saddle shoes tomorrow.
Bow tie?
Bow tie, of course, goes without saying. And but we have rented a boat at Lake Blackshear tomorrow.
How about that?
We rented a pontoon boat, so we're hoping the weather will be a little warmer, a little less windy. You know, I've owned a boat before, and, you know, they say the two happiest days in a boat owner's life is the day he buys it and the day he sells it. And as long as they're going to rent them pontoon boats down there.
You sign up?
I'll tell you
off the air what old man taught me about anything that I'll tell you off the air.
That'll be fine.
I can't
say
it on the air.
That'll be fine. We'll,
but I've owned a pontoon boat myself.
High fly ball. Is it in play?
That wind's carrying it. Oh, Jamar made a play at the wall. Good play by Jamar. Jumps up there to catch, makes the grab for out number one. I mean, it was right at the top of the wall.
That's awesome. That is awesome. Way to beat Jamar. But I tell you,
as you about took my head off.
I'm sorry. I didn't know. That was the cord. It wasn't me, I promise. But, yeah, we're going to – you know, my son, he loves to fish and all. And I may get me a little – like John Boat or Gnu or something for us to fish out at Wolf Creek or, you know, just kind of piddle around with down at Black Shear.
Well,
but I ain't going to spend the money on a big old boat and let it sit, you know, 6 months out of the year and not use a thing. That's like having a horse.
That horse will live 100 years to kill you.
That's right. A buddy of mine tried to give me a horse one time because he said, Scott, I got a horse. He said, I just want to give it to you. I said, no, I got a big hole in my backyard. I just throw cash in and burn already. If there's some horse fans in our house, we apologize. We know you love horses, but they anything that eats while I'm sleeping is just going to bankrupt me.
Yeah, that's right.
Alex Griffin, umpire, is not becoming a – I mean, Francis Marion fans love this umpire too much, I don't think. I think he's made a couple of calls that's caused them to have a little bit of unrest.
A little rumbling.
Swing and a miss. Griffith from Bristol, Virginia. He went to Virginia High School. That's a.
They just named the high school right after the state.
I guess. That's what it has on my list here. Swing and a miss. Strike three.
You know, Keith Micklegg has prepared us all these stats. I hadn't called out hardly a one of them. So I'm gonna do a better job of trying to. Yeah, like Keith said, we got 16 more innings.
Keith Micklegg, I call him the Rain Man of baseball.
He is.
Two outs for the second baseman, Patrick Jackson.
It's probably Brian doing it, and Keith just taking the credit. You think that's probably how it works?
Brian's nodding his head. Why you think why Keith's sitting back drinking coffee?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Sleeping late. High fly ball. Bo Halcombe makes the catch for out number three. So here we go to the bottom of the fourth on the Surge Sports Network. My step after that music between innings. Little Johnny Cash. I walked a line. Y'all couldn't hear it because YouTube would probably send a jolt of electricity through my headsets if we made it. But Cole stepping up his music choice. I saw some fans tapping their toes and smiling.
I think Cole enjoyed that song.
I think he did. Yeah, he did.
Oh, Cole says he says he knows it.
He's heard that one.
Don't know why he ain't ever played it before.
That's exactly right. Well, I mean, reality, once again, would suggest otherwise because he hasn't played it yet. Because if he knew it, he would know what a good song it was.
And, you know, I'm surprised Mick's behind him back here. He hadn't said a word all day. You. Time is called. It's
Scott Westbrook's putting his lunch order in to his wife right now, so he'll be back momentarily. There's a swing and a line drive, a hit up the middle for a base hit. Oh, yeah. I forgot to call the old Royale with cheese earlier.
We were too busy pushing it out over the left field fence.
Yeah, we, kind of like in golf, you know. Sit down, ball.
Matthew Mamata steps in there. I did get a phone call from my daughter. They're coming to bring my jacket now that it's about 85 degrees.
Look at right here.
Oh,
nice
look
lady.
At there, man. We've got some Easter cookies and pedophores.
Look at here.
Somebody has laid it on. Who was that? Who was that kind lady?
She's from Perry, Georgia.
That is. Hold on a second. Hold on a second.
That way you got the fence to protect.
Hold on.
Come
pitcher,
on,
pitcher. Give me his name. Help me out. Cole Garrett.
Was it
No. Hold on a second. Peyton Sales, mama.
That's it?
Look at there. How about that? I knew I'd get it eventually.
Look out.
Foul ball. Sorry, I'm yelling to the kids behind me. I apologize, fans, but that one was right behind me. Back here were some kids.
You get back in character.
I know. These kids playing behind me, you know, hit me with a ball a while ago.
Is that Mickley? Is that your kids?
That's okay. They don't mind them hit me with a ball. That's okay. I mean, I've been hit with worse. As long as they don't break a switch and come over here and strike my legs, I mean, you know, I'm good with them. Called strike.
Come on, Mamata. Stay hot, baby. So the wind's still blowing, but the sun is out.
Mm-hmm. Our shortstop.
Temporarily.
Steps in there. Line drive.
Blow in.
Left fielder. On his horse, not enough.
Right
over his
the
head.
Pose off sign.
Yes. Stand up double for Matthew Mamatis. Runners at second and third. Nobody out.
Nobody out. Mamatis 2-for-2 on tonight's game. So you know what? I think Mamatis is trying to send a message.
Jacob Harrell gets his steps in there once again in a good position to get some RBIs.
So Harrell won't be caught on the bunt here. He's going to be turned wide open right here. So Mamatis may be trying to say something to the Peach Belt.
I think so.
Boy,
he's pray they listening.
Hot.
Mamatis, one another one of those in the dugout you just visit with. He's just upbeat and
oh man, laid back.
Yep.
Great kid.
Mm-hmm. Ball outside. Jacob Harrell is, some like to say in baseball, good eye, Jacob. We're going to have to eat this chocolate. It's going to melt out here.
Tear it
up. Warm it well.
My wife, my daughter brought me a sandwich, some chips, some chocolate.
I'm hesitant to suggest this because of what happened a few minutes ago. But you want to pass it down to the end and see what we'll get back, you know. Let's see what.
They're about to tear me up.
Now, Reese's egg is yellow. Look at that.
In the spirit of Easter. As Harrell watches one look a little bit outside to me, but takes strike one.
Let me tell you something I saw last night, Ryan.
Strike two he took.
Okay.
Yep.
Runners at second and third. Harrell ready. Foul ball. Went to Columbus last night. Went into Ross, Dress for Less, Ross, you know. And let me tell you what's come out, and you're going to probably see it next year on some of the high school football fields. They have come out with a lot of these offensive linemen with these high-top, you know, they've been wearing high-top cleats since me and you were in high school. But they've got these crazy prints on these things. You know, you'll have the receivers have always been known to wear crazy shoes and all that kind of running backs. Now we're going to see offensive linemen out there. I saw some high-top cleats that had, like, Under Armour ones that had, like, crab prints on it and lobster prints and Superman logos and all. So wait till next year's high school football when we start seeing some of these offensive linemen who have always kind of been historically real conservative, not real flashy. It seems to be that the Under Armours and the Nikes and the Adidas's have decided they are going to
get in there and differentiate
their product a little bit.
As Harrell swings and misses at strike three, brings up a hot Beta at the plate. Jason Beta, what is he? Is he two for two?
I think so. Jason Beta.
No, he's two for three.
Our second baseman steps in there. Runners at second, third, one out.
Beta, his first at bat, hit one off the wall and right. His second at bat, hit one off the end of the bat to get a run in. His third at bat, a home run. So, pretty good day at the plate so far.
So, what has
Jason
he got?
Beta.
He's got a triple, a home run? No, does he? No. Yeah, he's got a triple and home run. So, we may get the cycle.
It's very – I mean, hey, if he could do it.
I mean, we're only in the
what
fifth inning, right?
Calling a double right here?
Well, let's see.
Second baseman Jason Beta.
If he
and
does.
I'm not sure if anybody's ever hit for the cycle since I've been here. Keith, can you remember if anybody's hit for the cycle?
I mean, he's got the two hardest ones already knocked out,
you
know?
He sure does.
I don't want to jinx him. I don't want to hear him from up here, you know?
He can't hear what we're saying.
I know, that's right. But still, man, yeah, get that single, not double, Jason. I think the double here and then maybe a leadoff single later on in the game.
Yeah, I'd like a double right here, especially with runners in scoring position.
That's right. My son, let me tell you one time I messed up with him. The ball hops in there. We were playing a little all-star game up in Crawford County. He was playing like 8 or 9 year old ball, and he had hit for the had hit every – you know, hit a single, double, triple. And we were winning big time by about 6 or 7 runs. And I almost came out of the stands to tell the coach, look, he's had a single, double, triple. If he gets close to a home – now, of course, it's 8-year-old baseball, but still. I said, if he gets – go ahead and send him. Go on and send him. Let's see if he can do it. I didn't because I ain't one of those parents that's going to go there and chirp in the coach's ears and tell him what to do. So I sat down. I kind of regret it now because he hit a triple and could have rounded second. And had, I mean, could have rounded home. The coach held him up at third, foul ball, held him up at third, but there was some runner interference. I mean, field, one, the guy, the shortstop was just kind of standing there, not paying attention and kind of blocked him. So the umpire came down there because the coach was like, hey, you know, he should be able to get home with that. The umpire said, well, if you hadn't held him up, I'd have given him, but you held him up.
Oh.
So, man, if I, you know, that's it. So I, and, of course, my kid had no idea. I had to explain to him what the cycle was on the way home. Beta swings at strike three. So, he's going to get a couple more chances.
Still some
yeah.
time.
Yeah, yeah. Tyler Skelton, third baseman, steps in there. I want to apologize to the fans for all our stories, but we got 16 innings to fill in.
Yeah, you had it. We're saving the best for later.
That's right. That's right.
I will tell you a little sad news, I guess it would be. Today marks 21 years today that Evan Bozoff passed away.
Wow.
And my wife always texts his mother, Miss Lynn, mm-hmm. on today mm-hmm. to let her know we're thinking about him.
Mm-hmm.
But Miss Lynn's no longer with us either. So today marks 21 years today where – You look out the left field. We've had a few balls hit over the sign. And
his sign's been active
today.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's number 17. Will never be worn here again at Georgia Southwestern. But hey, you know what? He was going to get in the medical field.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't have that. Obviously, was cut short of life. But crazy enough, he's not even here and still saving lives.
That's right. Yeah, exactly.
That's what's crazy.
Yeah, it is. I never thought of that, but you're right.
All right, Skip needs to fire that bat up, Scott.
Jamar on deck. Runners on second and third. Skelton takes ball four. Jamar steps in there, bases loaded.
You know, if you remember against Lander, that umpire – was a little – he had a slow call, you know.
Yes, yes.
You saw right there Skelton kind of hesitated that
yeah.
bat. He remembers that.
That's
umpire
exactly
from
right.
Plate.
And he was calling a lot of low and away pitches too, strikes. Has George Torbert just walked into the stadium?
George Torbert is here with us, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, good. How many golf balls he bought so far, I wonder?
George has bought some golf balls.
I think he has.
And his dad, George, and Dan Torbert's helped sell a pile of them.
That's
too.
Awesome. That is great. I figured George had. Well, I may have to get him to interview him during one of these 16 innings. Got a good crowd today. Even this little bit of cool weather is still.
It's a great crowd, yeah. And the weather's it's getting a little better as the day gets longer.
This weather has actually probably kept some people home from the lake today, so maybe they decided to come on out and watch a ball game.
And you stay tuned. I think we may show my buddy's number and got a nice retired number with his name and a baseball out there on the left field fence.
Low and away, Jamar takes the ball. Base is loaded. Huff at third. Beta at second. Skelton at first. Is that right?
I think believe so. You got it right.
Jamar at the plate.
Southwestern does have somebody down in the bullpen. I can't imagine unless, we try to put this game on out in a way that they'd take Tucker Smith out. Not this.
Rogers still out there pitching. Good to see Will Peterson walking in with his kids. Coming to enjoy the game today. This is one good thing about the scoreboard being broke, Keith. Think about how many people drive by just to kind of see what the score is. And they're going to probably stop and say, hey, I'm kind of curious what's going on with the scoreboard.
You got to be here to know what's happening.
You
got to
know what's happening. You either
tune in to. Mm-hmm.
Or you could do both.
That's right. Like Mr. Mamatis always does.
That's right. Jamar, foul ball. Got one out. Keith, is it two outs? Two outs. Okay, two outs. Bases loaded. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Rogers works his way out of a bind.
That's twice we've left the bases loaded this game, but guess what? We're still up.
That's right. Hogan will come out of house on the Surge Sports Network.
Leading off the fifth inning for Francis Marion is the shortstop, C.J. Mackinson.
Top of the sixth inning, C.J. Mackinson, shortstop for the Patriots, leads off against Tucker Smith. Top of the fifth? Okay, what did I say?
Six.
Did I really? I keep trying to wish an extra inning in there.
Well, you're ready to get on that boat Sunday.
No,
I
know. I'm ready for my jacket to get here because it just.
Well, I mean, yeah, I know you're thinking about your jacket, your food. I'm eating in front of you.
That's all right.
I have offered you something.
That's an incredible turkey sandwich. Your wife, that one was definitely made with some love right there. I mean, if it's got.
She takes care of me, Scott.
That's probably about 8 or 10 slices of turkey on that. A little pickle, a little lettuce, a little mustard.
She's the best.
You ain't even touched your chips yet.
I'm waiting for later.
Yeah, because that'll be probably microphone liable to
that'll
pick up
be
you.
Good. Crunch right
in
the air.
That's right.
Yeah, you want me to just eat live on the air?
Yeah, just start crunching.
They usually hear me licking my fingers. Mackinson facing Tucker Smith. We hope for another 3-up, 3-down inning. We got the number 8 batter, number 9 batter, and leadoff batter this inning. Due up this inning. Line drive falls to left center field. Hunter Foster fields it cleanly, throws it into second base, freezes the runner at first. Number 9 batter happens to wear number 9. Fred Wadsworth, third baseman for the Patriots, steps in there to face Smith.
Nobody out for the third baseman, Fred Wadsworth.
Man, that sun's got to feel good
it
to you,
It does,
Scott.
Man. I tell you. It just teases me, though, you know. Just warms me up and then, like, pulls a rug out from under me.
You know, I'm going to get really fired up here in a little bit. I'm getting fueled up.
Good.
My sandwich.
That sandwich ought to do it for you. I got a quarter pounder with cheese coming.
A Royale with cheese, like Beta already hit.
Yeah.
Beta's almost had 2 Royale with cheeses. And we missed that Royale with cheese call because, you know, we were just talking that wind and blowing that ball out of the ballpark, weren't we?
That's right. The wind now is blowing kind of a fortuitous breeze for the Patriots because it's blowing out in the center field and it's gusting pretty fairly well right now.
Got a few trucks out in the outfield, kind of out there behind the Bozoff sign.
Is that some students out there and some chairs on the trucks or –
I'm not sure, but it looks like they're having fun out there.
That's right. Foul ball. 2 strikes.
I believe that's right.
Wadsworth stands in there, waits for Tucker Smith to deliver. Swing and a miss, strike 3. Takes that forward K back to the dugout with him. Number 5, the leadoff batter, Will Hardy, steps in there with 1 out. Runner on first, facing Tucker Smith.
1 out for the left fielder, Will Hardy.
Left fielder for the Patriots. Left-handed batter. Wind blowing towards left field right now.
A good-looking blonde has come into the game.
She sure has.
Scott.
After slaving over making you a great sandwich. Besides, yeah, that was a good-looking sandwich.
She could have brought you one.
Well, I was coveting it. I just sat here and coveted it. I didn't want to, you know, there was only enough for one person there, really.
Try to keep this candy from melting.
That's it.
Chance for 2.
4, 6. Oh, man. Fielder's choice. Got the runner at 2nd. Runner throw got away. A little errant. That came in a kind of tight because the runner was already there at 2nd. It was a close play at 2nd, which may have made the throw a little errant. But
Mamatis may have rushed his throw a little bit there and threw it, but no harm, no foul. We got the lead runner. We got 2 outs. No big deal.
At the plate, right fielder Cole Hennant.
Cole Hennant, right fielder, steps in there with 2 outs, runner on 1st.
Oh,
no,
Kemp.
Sorry. Number 40, we got a pinch. Brent Kemp, freshman from Wilmington, North Carolina.
The plate is number 40, Brett Kemp.
Those Francis Marion folks giving us a little help right there.
We appreciate it.
Absolutely. We can't see everything.
No. I mean, you know, if I was perfect, nobody could afford me. Kind of foul tip, strike 1. Man, I wish. I tell you, how about that? These cookies. And
I tell you what.
We're going to have to start bringing us a cooler here.
I'm afraid if I bring a cooler, I couldn't make it through the second game.
I think you need to next weekend. I think you and I, because we were a little worried earlier in the season because we really weren't comfortable with what we're doing. We got comfortable enough now. I think we pushed the envelope a little bit.
You think we can flirt with bringing a cooler?
Yeah, I think so. I think fans at home would appreciate it.
I guarantee you.
YouTube, maybe not so much.
You can say anything on YouTube.
I think so, yeah. We're not controlled by the FCC yet. The man has not got his foot on her neck yet.
They got bigger fish to fry.
Mm-hmm. Kemp stands in there, waits for the delivery. Tucker Smith. Oh, swing, strike three. That'll do it for the top of the fifth inning on the Surge Sports Network. Center fielder Hunter Foster steps in there. We got a same pitcher, Mr. Rogers, Weston Rogers, number 48, still pitching in there for the Francis Marion Patriots. High and away, Hunter Foster takes that pitch as a ball. If some of you are arriving late to the game, wondering or checking in late, we've got a
George Torbert. Hey, you got a heckler back here.
George Torbert has just stepped in. I'm surprised he knew his way to the ball field since we hadn't seen him here all year. What you want to eat?
I don't know. I think he has something.
Well, here you go. Give him a piece of that candy. Give him a piece of that candy. Come here. Sorry, fans. I apologize. We distracted. Hunter Foster in there to bat. I did have a heckler. This is once again why we need a press box. We need to be able to cut the riffraff out. This little chain day off area we have right here does not. I mean, I'm worried about our safety.
I am too at times,
you know.
But we got Micklick here as Hunter Foster draws a walk, and that's going to bring up a pinch hitter,
number 31, Miguel Urbina. Urbina been battling an injury most of the season. Has come in late and had some good clutch hits for us this season.
He has. One of the ones that stand out the most to me is the one in Columbus, that home run he hit in game one over there to help win the game. Urbina has been plagued with a hamstring injury. I believe he's 100% better with his hamstring. Now he's fighting a thumb issue.
My goodness. Josh trying to work him into the lineup any way he can. You want to get like that.
Typically, Urbina comes in and he's going typically DH when there's a lefty out on the mound.
Francis Marion fans not liking that call.
They getting on the umpire pretty good, and he's shaking his head. Maybe he may throw somebody out of the game back here.
Yeah, exactly right. I just don't want them to think we are questioning his calls. I've really had absolutely no questionable calls from him so far.
So Urbina watches. Swung on and missed by Urbina. Aren't you a Canes 360 member?
You know what? I am about to join. I am. I've trying to get all my other ducks in a row, but I do want to. I want to pay my daughter's way. I'm sorry, y'all. I had to break away. My lovely daughter and her boyfriend are here, and I got to get them in the ball game. What? I'm sorry, Urbina. Did he swing it? Strike three.
Struck out.
Oh my goodness. Bo Halcomb steps in there. Runner at first. Two out. One out or two outs? One out. One out. Halcomb stands in there. Faces Rogers. Rogers delivers ball one. Errant ball rolls behind the umpire.
Yeah. Look, Scott, I think if the players, you know, I can't remember how many names they let them give at the gate, but, you know, announcers at least get two.
You would think. Okay, thank you. I don't mind paying for my daughter.
I know. Hey, you're fine.
Well.
I think, look, unless you see Mike Leader come up here and just throw him out of the game, how about that?
Well, that's it. That's what I'll do. Leader was here a while ago, but
I think he wanted to go inside and listen to us.
I'm sure. He showed up just in time to recognize the fact that we had no scoreboard, no PA. It's just like my kids say, you know, anytime they're watching a TV show, they could be watching it for 3 hours, and the one time their mom walks through theirs is like the worst part of it. Leader walks up, and everything's going great, and then Leader walks up after the storm.
He brought the wind with him.
Foul ball back into the screen. Bo Halcomb.
Now that it's hot, Scott, your family's brought you some clothes.
Some food.
Foster's going, there's no
call
chance.
Strike, that's right, yeah. Hunter Foster had a great jump on that play. Gets another stolen base.
So as soon as we talk about a few innings ago of us not having that many stolen bases, we've already stole two on the day, Keith.
Bo Halcomb took that strikeout, swinging, but with runner advances on the stolen base. Bradley Huff steps in there, our first baseman, with two outs, runner in scoring position.
Huff stands in there. He's 3-for-3 on the day. Scott swung on, fouled away.
Wind blowing to straight out to center field. We can get a high fly. Deep ball that direction.
And it may
get
pushed. It.
Yes, sir. You know, the Canes came right out of the gates like their hair was on fire, scoring runs and all. But the past few innings, Mr. Rogers has slowed them down a little bit.
But Huff may have something to say about that.
especially with this wind gusting right now. He has to feel it too and know that he wants to put the ball up in this stuff right now. Ooh, swing and a miss. 15-mile-per-hour winds. Was that a curveball he waved at just then?
Ryan, I couldn't tell.
I think so.
You know, not Keith is so talented. I mean, he gives us wind speed.
Guy has the owner's manual for a scoreboard. Chopper. Hit to the third baseman. Fields it cleanly. Throws to first for out number three. So we go to the top of the sixth inning. Up 8-1.
8-1.
On the Surge Sports Network.
Leading off the sixth inning for Francis Marion.
So Gage Taylor steps up.
Gage Taylor.
For Francis Marion, and we got a pitching change as Cole Garrett's come on the pitch for the Hurricanes. As he throws from the stretch, works quick, got one in there, called strike one. So Cole had a pretty solid weekend last weekend against Lander. I think he pitched about four innings or so. Five innings against Lander. Slider misses, ball two. So the count's 1-1. Fastball swung on, hit ground ball out to Mamatis. Fields throws. So Cole Garrett comes in quickly and gets out number one for the Hurricanes. You like to see that with Cole Garrett coming out of the bullpen. As the umpire is in disbelief, he's looking at the ball to make sure there's nothing wrong with the ball. Tell him we do that a lot around here. We throw ground balls all the time, right? That brings up Nick Papapas. So Cole Garrett works from the stretch. The pitch, fastball missed outside for ball one. So
that's my first baseman, Nick Pappas.
We got very good work out of Tucker Smith, as always. And Tucker will take the rest of the night off, or during this game especially, for sure.
as Cole Garrett throws a fastball, misses again for ball two. Pappas hits from the left-hand side of the plate, and Scott Westbrook's joined me again. He's been trying to keep his weight up a little bit.
Errant football lands in front of us, falls in the stands.
Yeah, we've had enough. We can't afford to lose any more equipment today.
Called strike. Cole Garrett gets in there, working pretty efficient so far.
1-2. 2-1, rather.
Yeah, I did have to scarf down a burger. You know, the chopper hits.
Oh.
Did it hit first base?
Hit the bag.
I thought it did.
Yeah. Weird hop. So.
Yeah. I tell you, you've seen some odd things today.
Today,
you
know? We really have seen a couple right off the end of the bat, some plays, and just that was a unique play. And a tough break for the Canes as Huff.
One out. Coming to the plate, designated
would have normally
hitter,
fielded that.
Gonzalez.
He got us an out, but that's okay.
I mean, let's be honest, we've gotten most of the breaks today.
We really have, yeah.
So, I mean, that, you know, it, hopefully Cole Garrett can work past that one right through it, because that was just a tough break right there for the Canes.
Cole, again, it's hard to believe, you know, we've left the bases loaded twice this game, and Canes still lead 8-1.
Lenny Gonzalez steps in there. I think Lenny looks like he's batting in the number 5 spot. I think Lenny's probably gotten a hold of a ball or two and give it a ride. I hope he doesn't today. He's battled in there, hit a few foul balls. Wind blowing from right to left.
There's
6-4-3. Double play. Cole Garrett comes in, works his magic. Here we go to the bottom half of the inning on the Surge Sports Network. Number 7, Matthew Mamata steps in there, ready to face Mr. Rogers.
And Scott, big gentleman, just stepped over here and tapped me on the shoulder. Coach Ben Hicks is in the house with us, our basketball coach at GSW.
Glad to have Coach Hicks here with us.
He's been hot on the recruiting trail, doing a fantastic job. He said he hadn't been to Panama City yet, though. Doing too much recruiting.
That's probably a smart move. I can't go to Panama City and wait for 2 hours to eat somewhere, man. I tell you, that's what.
You got to go with Sparky.
That's right. I told you that before.
You go with Sparky Reeves, you don't have to wait in line in Panama City. I don't care who you are. You go to Angelo's, brother, you go front of the line.
I go to Whataburger. I don't have to wait at Whataburger. More my budget. Look at that. That's going to be a single.
Play. Look at Mamadas.
Mamadas.
So, Mamadas now 3 for 3 on the day.
Jacob Harrell walks to the plate. Runner at first, nobody out. Weston Rogers has worked himself out of a couple of binds today. The pitcher has worked himself out of a couple of binds today.
I'm sorry, Scott.
That's okay.
I got the wind blowing in my ear.
You got up to dance. No, you can sit there.
I really did.
Got up to dance on that one because Harold's walk-up music, we both like it. But some of us keep our seat and continue to work while the other one does a table dance.
It did. That, you know, we could be on the other side of this thing. You know, with that ball hit foul going out of play, normally that ball would have been past the dugout. It almost blew it back into took off a piece of shingle.
I saw the some of the Francis Marion parents just had a big old Subway sandwich delivery. So I guess the Patriots are going to eat Subway sandwiches between innings. Because they were unaware of Carter's Fried Chicken, I suppose.
Carter's and Roman Oven.
That's exactly right, yeah.
You know, our sponsors, they should have just asked.
We could have told them.
Zaxby's?
Yeah.
Kidding me?
Come on now. Yeah, Roman Oven, man. Yeah, that's that right there. We'd have helped them out because they helped us out during our storm damage before the game.
Oh, absolutely. If they need advice, we'll give them great advice.
Tell them where to eat. Where not to eat, more importantly.
That's right.
Where not to eat are places that won't sponsor GSW. That's the ones we steer them away from.
I tell you, we have some great sponsors, though. You know, we have
McDonald's.
Walking Wings that has helped with our hailstorm. You have the new gyro place, or Euro, whatever you want to call it. What's it called? Euro City?
I love that place. We
it
love the little
fantastic.
Tea, the tea they give you.
Yeah.
They give you that little sweet tea, whatever it is. I don't know what it's
Walking
called.
Walking Wings is great, too, man.
Walking Wings is clean as a whistle, man. You go in there.
Yeah.
You
owned by Peter Lee, a hurricane golfer.
I'm telling you, I know some very Tukey folks. And you bring up Walking Wing, and those Tukey folks will sit there and talk about how clean it is. Some of these women.
It's crystal clean.
Yeah, that's it. If you want
and
to
let
go
me tell you, the service you get, Peter Lee's always back there cooking.
Yeah.
And then you go to Euro City, and that place, that the owner of that place will come out. He's
he acts
so
like
nice.
You're the only customer there, man. When you're in there, man, he may have a table full of folks, but he's going to go there and treat you like you're the only customer
there. He
does. There.
You got, and you know, there's really a lot of little hidden gems here in America.
That I have found most of them, as you can tell by looking at me.
You have. So if you need to know, as a matter of fact, our baseball coach, Coach McDonald, was asking some places to eat, and I told him believe it or not, I just shut up and let Scott talk.
Yep. Oh, my goodness.
Almost mishandled out there.
It was. You know, he kind of rolled it in. The shortstop took it. It was 6-4-3 nonetheless, but he kind of mishandled and rolled it in there, you know, to the second baseman. The second baseman had to pick it up and make a quick throw to get the Harrell running down the first baseline. All right, Jason Beta steps up there and hopes of – oh, your lovely wife came over here. She, I guess, finished with that and brought it over here for you to use.
I got a good wife.
You do. Swing and miss, Jason Beta. Base is empty, nobody out. Score 8-1. I'm gonna tell you, Rogers came in. Like I said, when Rogers came in, he a little rattled, gave up a few runs, but he has settled down and
he settled down and done a good job for Francis Marion. I tell you, I had 4 or 5 players come up to me before the game and said, "Hey, I met your father-in-law."
Mm-hmm.
So apparently, you know, Mr. Sparky picked him out. I'm not sure how he picked him out either. They were wearing GSW gear, but
right.
Or he did the Scott Westbrook, did some profile and figured out that they were baseball players. Yeah. I don't know.
Well,
but
I'll tell
they
you
got
what.
To meet my father-in-law. And
you ain't got to worry about these boys that we got on the baseball team going and embarrassing us. I can tell you that.
I don't think so,
no.
Either, buddy. They they're some great guys.
Come from good raising, good stock.
Yeah, your mom and daddies, if you're listening in, you'll be proud of these boys. think they all do pretty good in the classroom.
The worst influence they have down here is Ryan Young and Scott Westbrook.
There's no doubt about that. It's Beta. Look here. Watch out.
Oh, my goodness. That left fielder made a great play. But Beta hit another one deep. It was Will Hardy out there in left field for out number three. Beta still on the track for that, hitting for the cycle. Yes, sir. But anyway, here we go. That's on the Surge Sports Network. We're going to go to the dangerous half of the inning.
Top of the seventh.
Alex Griffin, catcher, steps in there. Here comes some more food for the Francis Marion players.
Catcher Alex Griffin.
Number six batter leads off the inning for the Patriots, facing Cole Garrett.
You know, Scott, I mean, from an economic standpoint, you got to think, well, you're having a university in your town. I mean, you look, these guys have probably gone to Walmart, they went to Subway. They're going to buy gas here. They stay in here.
Food
line. All the traffic we pull in here in Americus, Georgia.
That's it.
Just from Georgia Southwestern State University, man. So,
I mean, look at all this food they're bringing in. They're going to feed an army.
Well, they got one down in that dugout.
Yes, sir. Oh, we got a whole new shipment. Looks like some food's going to the Hurricanes dugout, too.
They have a contest.
I ain't seen one chicken gizzard walk across here, though, I can tell you that.
They got those hid.
Well, I'm telling you, you want these boys to win some ball games, you need to let me sit there and write the – I mean, I know you got hired nutritionists and all that kind of stuff, but a between-game meal, chicken gizzards.
Would that be on your menu?
Tater tots.
As a nutritionist?
Yes, yes.
You know what? You should go apply for a couple of nutritionist jobs. Just – hell, they ought to just hire you on the spot just by looking at you.
I have got too many irons in the fire as it is right now. You know, I'm doing the emceeing of the America's Got Talent show. And I have been practicing some of my sorcery, also known as magic tricks, to perform during my emceeing.
You blew Tucker Smith's mind last week.
I know,
man.
Yeah.
Handkerchief trick.
I see it. Cole Garrett gets ready to deliver to the Patriot catcher high and away.
I had to just miss outside.
Yeah, some of the Cane fans weren't too happy with that call.
You know, the only thing we're missing, well, we're missing a couple, I think, but Matt Lamothe's parents was here last weekend. His girlfriend was here. Even his girlfriend, she brought her mama down here.
Really?
All of them from, I think,
Wisconsin.
Up around, in the Wisconsin area.
We got to stop importing these West. We got to stop importing all these Wisconsin folks. You know, Mick Lee, we brought him from there. I think we're at our quota.
You think so?
Canadians
well,
and Wisconsinites.
She, she's on the way down. So,
okay, well, that's fine.
She's soon be graduating.
We closing the gate after we bring her in here. Yeah. I tell you, good. You have salt of the earth. I know. I kid Mick League, but I have yet to meet somebody from Wisconsin I don't like.
We've struck rich in Wisconsin.
Yeah, Wisconsin and Canada both.
Lamothe sure has.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. 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 Is that the helicopter? Are they going to drop some golf? No, that's, I'm sorry. That's the one coming from the hospital. I thought helicopter coming in here. I thought we were about to. They got the wrong memo.
I tell you what, we got a bigger helicopter than that right there, buddy. Mm. We got the Huey from the Friends of the Army, and we can't thank them enough. Friends of the Army Aviation.
Sylvester, Georgia. Is that where y'all went and saw them?
We went there. They were doing a little something there, but these guys are actually from Ozark, Alabama.
Oh, wow.
And they're excited to drop these golf balls.
Patrick Jackson, second baseman, fouls it away. Catcher Alex Griffin stands at first base.
No, Cole, the only job, I mean, Cole just needs to come in and just throw strikes.
Yeah. And you got a seven run lead.
Challenge these hitters.
Yeah.
That was the kind of win that just took us out.
That's exactly earlier. Right. So you saw everybody grab what was dear and dear to them. I went straight and held my French fries down. I sure didn't want French fries strewed all over the sidewalk and attracting ants. High and away, ball. What do we got, a 3-1 count or 2-1? What is it?
I believe it's 3-1.
3-1. 3-1.
Come on, Cole. Just settle down. Challenge these hitters.
It's number seven, batting the number seven spot, Patrick Jackson. You know, the Magnolia Manor folks, Mick Ligger, like the Magnolia Manor bus is showing up. This was supposed to be Magnolia Manor Day here today. We had some seats set up for them under the tent.
And we understand why they're
yes
getting here a little late.
Yeah, it's me of all people, I understand that.
As Coach Matt LaMotha go have a word with Cole Garrett, we'll take a short break. You're listening to the Surge Sports Network. All right, so the meeting on the mound is over. Cole Garrett to get back to work. He works out of the stretch, got runners on first and second. Fastball misses over for ball one. Cole just needs to settle down, challenge these hitters. Hurricanes lead 8-1. Ball two. Hurricane bullpen getting busy again. Hayden Martin out in the bullpen getting loose.
Cole Garrett throws low and away. That's C.J. Mackinson in batting, the shortstop for the Patriots. Called strike. Line drive single to right field. Jamar fields it cleanly. Throws into home. Stops the runner. We got the bases loaded. Nobody out. Is that right?
That's right.
Number nine batter, Fred Wadsworth, third baseman.
Cole's just got to start working, getting ahead of these hitters. Quit working from behind.
Nobody out.
And challenging. Baseman Fred Wadsworth. 7-run lead here by the Hurricanes. Still plenty of baseball to play. Good pitch.
Swing and a miss.
Good curveball right there. Just got word our Lady Canes playing Flagler on the road. They're tied up in the top of the ninth, 3-3. So we're wishing our Lady Canes good luck up at Flagler. I think our Lady Canes have clinched a playoff or a or postseason berth, rather. So we, you know, now just still want to go in there with the highest seed we possibly can, Scott, as the Magnolia Manor bus is unloading. Got a lot of people getting out of that bus.
They, I tell you what, they seized the opportunity as the sun came out to come on up here and enjoy the game. They are coming in the middle of a, you know, pretty good game. The Canes have had their way, but it looks like the Patriots are trying to mount a rally here late in the innings.
Cole does have two strikes on the hitter. Good job by Jacob Harrell blocking that ball up. I can tell you from experience, a catcher moving his feet like that, getting over there, gives you a lot of confidence to throw any pitch in this situation with the bases loaded. And
look at, whoa, yeah.
So
Harrell got back there, and runner going from third. He put the brakes on. Almost had a miss.
Almost, which would have been nice.
That's right. Man. So we
so
got.
As I say, Harrell's not but so tall.
That's right.
He can block them in the dirt, but when you start throwing them over his head, he's not going to be able to get but to so many of them.
And we got a 2-2 count. Is that where we are? 2-2. Oh, 3-2. We got a full count. Full count, bases loaded, nobody out. Number 9 batter up.
Nowhere to put him, Scott.
No, we need an SO right here. That's it. Take that backwards K. Take the long walk to the dugout.
Good pitch.
That was a huge strikeout. One out. Now we got bases juiced. Leadoff batter Will Hardy, left fielder, who made that heck of a play on his horse to, I believe, Rob Beta, wasn't it? Was it Beta that hit that one?
Yeah, hit it out. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
One out for the left fielder, Will Hardy.
Wadsworth Garrett did not agree with that third called third strike.
That was a good pitch. Mm-hmm. Harrell again with another good stop back there. Curveball in the dirt. Kind of caught a break there because that thing looked like it almost hit way too far out in Harrell and bounced over his head. You know, the catcher's reading that ball. He's going down. That ball almost bounced over Harrell.
One ball, no strikes. Two balls, no strikes to Hardy. Hardy, the leadoff batter for Francis Marion Patriots.
George Torbert just came over here and he wants he hates for you to miss out on any of your friends. He said there's a class reunion going over there for you is what he was saying, Scott.
You know, George, the only reason he stopped today is because the scoreboard was off. He normally would just drive right past, not visit us. But now he wants to come up here and rattle our cage. And fans, yeah, this just shows how desperately we need a press box here to keep the riffraff from harassing us while we're trying to do our job.
Good pitch. But I tell you what, really, you know, the relationship that Georgia Southwestern and the Magnolia Manor has, you know, yeah, the retirement community out there, what a what a great partnership. Glad to have them out on campus with us. Welcome them back anytime.
Man, they don't have to have a special day. They can come out here anytime they want
Absolutely.
To.
Absolutely. Mark Todd, matter of fact, Mark played baseball here, I think, back in the day. CEO for the Magnolia Manor.
Chopper. That's
just
trouble.
Get one, and that's going to be hard to do.
Yeah. So that's an infield hit. Hard, high chopper to third baseman, and just everybody running on that one. And it was because being a ground ball, everybody had to run like their hair was on fire. And just a tough, tough play.
Right fielder Brett Kemp.
And Scott, we're getting right in the meat of their lineup with the bases loaded. So,
yes, number two batter.
The Hurricanes still lead 8-2, one out. Top of the seventh inning.
Kemp calls timeout, gets it. It'd have been nice. I mean, I wouldn't have mind giving up a run then if we could have got out on that one, you know?
Yeah.
But really, the most probable play would have been at the plate. But, you know, by the time the ball.
If we'd have known the ball was going to react like that, we wouldn't have put the tarp on the field Friday.
That's exactly right. Ball outside. Kemp, 6'2", 200-pound freshman from Wilmington, North Carolina. Swing and a miss. Garrett delivers, fouled away.
Boy, a big strikeout right here would be real nice.
It sure would. It would. Get that second out. I'd like for Francis Marion to leave about bases loaded a couple. Well, not, I don't want to. I'd like them to leave the bases loaded this inning.
Yeah. And just soon not and get it that way again.
No, it's exactly not getting us by it again. High fly ball, left field. Bo Halcomb backs up. Runner at third tags, and it's going to score easily, but first and second stays there, makes the score 8-3. But we get the sacrifice fly, gets us the all-important second out.
I was beginning to worry because he was coming in, as Halcomb was coming in, he had to drift back. And as that ball started drifting, started looking a little bit like Beta's home run there for a second.
Two outs. Center fielder Gage Taylor.
Gage Taylor steps in there, number 10, center fielder. Some of our fans out in left field in the back of their trucks leaning on the fence now.
Maybe they'll have a lot more to say. They'll have a lot to say next inning.
I hope so. I can get a little chirpy out there.
Good pitch by Garrett.
That one froze Gage Taylor at the plate. No swing, called strike.
You feel a little warmer with your jacket on,
Scott? It is a little more better, I can tell you that.
Just a little more better?
Yeah, it's a little more better.
Uh-oh.
No, it's a line drive. Come on, Jamar.
Jamar's going to have a hard time catching up to that.
That was a hot shot line drive. One run scores, two run scores on that stand-up double. Line drive double clears the bases. Coach McDonald is coming out, probably going to make a pitching change. We will break away, have a break on the Surge Sports Network.
So Hayden Martin comes in to pitch for the Hurricanes. Yes, he's going to face.
Two outs. The batter, first baseman, Nick Pappas.
He's going to face Nick Pappas. Fastball inside for ball one.
Hayden Martin, sophomore, 5'11", from Woodstock, Georgia, River Ridge High School. Took a little something off that pitch. Pappas stands in there, waits for Martin's delivery. Martin checks the runner at second. Throws one high and inside. That was a little tight. I don't know. They called ball four,
little,
so.
A little in. Not a good start for Martin, but got runners on first and second.
Number 32, Lenny Gonzalez steps in there. Gonzalez, designated hitter. Looks like he's a switch hitter. Wasn't he batting? Wasn't he a left-handed batter?
Let's see.
I think. I think he batted from the left-handed side last time.
I can't remember.
Gonzalez gets in there in the right hand. Micklig confirms my suspicions.
I think it was Cole.
Who was it?
Cole gave you some.
Oh, was it Cole? Confirmed it. Thank you, Cole. Switch hitter. High and away.
Scott, we got to be able to find the plate.
I know. We have, man, that's just discouraging. We're up by three runs, 8-5. Tie and run at the plate. Takes another ball.
Hurricane bullpen starting to stir again. I'm guessing that's going to be Snyder down there.
You know, I went over there and offered ball four. Bases loaded. I went over there and offered George and Steven Snyder some of my candy. They looked at me very suspicious, like I was trying to give them something that was going to do. You know, there's a lot of things that
You just did get back from Colorado.
Well, I know, but I'm telling you, there's a lot of things I cut to fool on, but food ain't one of them. That's a little too serious. Oh.
As Jacob Harrell goes out to the mound, try to settle down Martin, or either buying time for the bullpen to get warm.
Umpire's going to break that up probably. All right, bases loaded, two outs. Catcher Alex Griffith stands in there. Score 8-5.
Two outs for the catcher, Alex Griffith.
So, Griffith would be the lead runner. Some of these Francis Marion fans walking by with an ice cream cone. I wonder where they got that.
It's kind of like a fire, man. You know, it doesn't matter how hot it is. Ice cream's good anytime.
I know, but I'm like sitting there thinking, they know of an ice cream place that I don't. Ball low.
Just got to dig deep here and get this out for the Hurricanes, get us out of this mess. 8-5, bases loaded, two outs, top of the seventh.
We got nowhere to put him. Hmm. That three balls, no strikes?
Got a strike.
Oh, good one strike. Okay, good. Swing and a miss. He was swinging for the fence with that one. They harassing us from the peanut gallery, Ryan, again. Get campus security, campus law enforcement over here.
Good job.
Swing and a miss. Strike three. Big third out. Left three on the pond. That'll do us for the inning. We'll go to the bottom half. Canes up 8-5 on the Surge Sports Network. New pitcher, Colby Lee from Latta, South Carolina. Latta High School, 6'2", 185-pound junior, right-handed pitcher. Comes in there with the Hurricanes leading 8-5. We need to put some more runs on the board.
Scott, we're going to have a big inning right here.
I hope so. Tyler Skelton, our number two batter, leads off the inning. Hopefully can get us going. I tell you, being Magnolia Manor Day, it was a perfect time for me to give Cole my playlist. Little Johnny Cash, Ring of Fire.
That's it. As Skelton gets beaned, and he'll dust it off and walk down the first base or jog down the first.
I told Cole to make sure he plays my songs during the pitching change, and look what happened. First pitch, hit batter.
He's learning.
I'm telling you.
Coachable. He's coachable.
Cole's one of my favorite coachable DJs.
You know, we'll give Coach McDonald a little advice and tell mm-hmm. him, hey, look, you did a good job. You got Cole up here. He is a coachable player.
Yes, that's right. Jonathan Martin.
Jonathan Martin, Irwin County native, right fielder, stands in there to face Kobe Lee after Kobe Lee has been iced by Johnny Cash. Ball.
Two in a row.
Yes, sir. Now, I'm hoping Cole will do what I have instructed him to do. If we have a pitch, we rattle this pitcher, pitch and change, the Auctioneer song by Leroy Van Dyke.
If he don't, we're going to hold him down and shave his head.
That's it.
And we just may be too grown big enough men to do it.
Well, really, if you can get him on the ground, I can finish him off with this 300-pound figure. I promise you that. We're going to block the entrance and exit to this chained-in area. You what's the problem?
All right, we're going to have a visit to the mound. And
he's saying, look.
We will take a short break. You're listening to the Surge Sports Network.
Oh, Cole. Ryan, he finally plays a good song. We got Auctioneer song by Leroy Van Dyke played during the warm-up pitcher for this new pitcher, number 28, Patrick Orlando from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, junior, 5'10", 175 pounds, junior. Jamar in there to face him. I tell you, just a whole new atmosphere. Fans seem to be really enjoying themselves, dancing.
Absolutely. Me and you did a little do-si-do, didn't we?
We did. We danced a little bit. Look at that.
See, we got Cole's mind is spinning over here. So he thinks he's got another good song. Timberlake's dad was jamming down there.
Of course. That goes without saying. It's a good song. And I'm telling you what, you take these 18 to 22-year-old pitchers, and they want to hear some music, get them pumped up, and you throw a bucket of ice on them with some of the songs I pick out. Ooh, man. So and you get three balls and the questionable called strike one, but That's okay, Jamar. That's right. I'm telling you, it's just like in Vegas. When somebody comes in hot, you put a cooler over there next to them.
Kind of like Cousin Eddie coming to see you.
That's right. Swing and a miss. Well.
Well, you can't win them all, Scott.
No, you can't. That's all right. Hunter Foster, center fielder, steps in there. Runner at first. I think we got one out. Trying to get us some insurance runs here. Swing and a miss.
Kind of a unique delivery there.
Yeah, I'm telling you, it's almost a short delivery, really. I mean, he's wind up. Next thing you know, that ball's coming out of his hand. He got his toe on the very far side of the rubber. Ball counts 1-1.
Foster's due. Like to see Foster just get a hold of one right here and hit it over that Bozo sign.
Especially the wind blowing straight away center field. Did he call a strike on that one? What's the count? What? Did he call a strike on that one, Brian? So counts what? 1-2.
Our Lady Canes did. I think we got beat, what, in the 10th inning, Brian? So the Lady Canes lose the first game today, but.
Man, strike three. Hunter Foster, Miguel Urbina. Yeah, it's not my auctioneer song.
We need to trash that auctioneer song.
Come on now. All right, I deserve that.
Batting designated hitter Miguel Urbina.
Miguel Urbina steps in there. Two outs, runner on first. Canes up 8-5. Call strike one. Patrick Orlando coming in. Working quite efficiently so far. Two strikeouts. Ball low and away. Urbina hits one. Straight center field. He takes just two steps back, catches it for out number three. So that'll do us. Go to the top half of the – which inning? Eighth? Are we at the eighth? Yes, eighth inning. Up 8-5 on the Surge Sports Network. Martin's still in there pitching, top of the eighth inning.
I think Tucker Smith is the pitcher on record right now. So the Canes went Smith, Garrett, Martin. Wouldn't hurt my feelings to see Martin finish this game out strong right here for sure.
Mm-hmm. 1-1. Didn't realize how difficult it was to call a game without a scoreboard.
It's tough.
I mean, you know,
I tell you though, with the technology today, though, pull it up on live stats. Brian's doing a good job down there.
Second baseman Patrick Jackson
keeping us up to speed there.
Patrick Jackson, second baseman, has a count of 1-2 right now. 2-2.
Why don't you use one of your 8 telephones and put down there for a paperweight, Scott?
I have, man. I tell you, this wind, man. Whew. You know, if it wasn't for the wind out here, this day would be just about a perfect day. But this wind is just killing us. I was a little too close to take with 2 strikes, but he got the ball. He got the call, Jackson. Maybe just a frog hair closer. Strike 3. Got that leadoff batter out. All
I like that saying, Cole Garrett. I mean, Cole down here is talking about the ball don't lie.
That's right.
Cole Trickle.
Number 16, shortstop, C.J. Mickelson.
Mackinson,
I'm sorry. Ladies and gentlemen, I have a hard time reading the lineup.
Too much, he's freezing.
Well, the thing is, you know, it's the copy of a copy of a copy with these old where it's got the little carbon stuff, and I think see if it's Mackinson or Mickelson or.
Well, but nevertheless, he came into the day's game batting .262.
He's batting in the number 8 spot, number 2 batter in this inning.
172 at-bats this year.
Hard ground ball hit to the first baseman.
Good job by Martin. 2 batters, 2 outs.
Two outs for the batter, third baseman Fred Wadsworth.
Bradley Huff took that ball himself, tagged the base. So Martin faces third batter of the inning with 2 outs.
Wadsworth came in the game batting .242. He does have 3 home runs on the year. Martin, like Cole Garrett coming out of the bullpen, always comes out with no runners on and still works out of the stretch.
Mm-hmm. Foul ball. Behind the magnolia tree towards the swimming pool, down the right field side, out of play. Ground ball, third baseman, fielded cleanly.
Good job.
Throws
Skelton
to Huff. Skelton to Huff for out number 3. Yes,
by
sir.
Martin.
Here we go, bottom of the 8th, up 8-5. Bo Halcom steps in there, face Mr. Orlando. Mr. Orlando worked very efficiently last inning. We'll see if he's going to carry it over to this inning.
Leading off the home half of the
Halcom, our number six batter, leads off the bottom of the eighth inning. Called strike one. Wind gusts again for our Hurricanes.
I don't mind the gust in the outfield when we're at the plate.
No, I don't either. I mean, it's just it's played out pretty well for us in this game. I think both sets of parents have set up between meal games for the players. One ball, two strikes.
I believe that's
no
right.
Outs, no outs. Bottom of the eighth. 2-2. Halcom takes a stroll out on the grass. Maybe to mess up the pitcher's timing a little bit. This pitcher obviously likes to work quickly.
He works very quick.
Mm-hmm. He's getting a little frustrated, too, and so Halcom's going to frustrate him a little more. Take the Nomar Garcia para.
He took forever,
he
didn't
he? He did, man. Human rain delay. Bo did that on purpose, I'm sure. Not a bad call. Swing and a miss. That catcher took off running like he thought it was third out, but that's just one out. Bradley Huff, first baseman.
One out. First baseman up, Bradley Huff.
Stands in there.
You know, I got Mix back here, and I'm really not sure what Mix's role is up here, but I got to put him to work doing something. I'm looking down there at him trying to remind me of how many hits our guys have, and I'm going to put him on the spot here.
He's taking the role as shovel inspector, like a DOT supervisor. I have not become a fan of Mr. Orlando, the pitcher, but, of course, I'm not a Francis Marion fan. If I was a Francis Marion fan, I might like him because he has.
As he wasn't even, the umpire wasn't even ready there for the pitch, so I guess that was a no pitch.
Right. That umpire looks at the dugout. Must not like to hear some chirping coming from the dugout.
Well, it wasn't the head coach because he's just walked right by us.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. We kind of need to know what's going on. Okay, so it must have been no pitch, or yeah, I would. One thing about, I mean, Mr. Orlando has come in here and had our number for the last few batters, but he does like to work quickly. So our batters are kind of stepping out, taking their time a little bit between pitches.
Well, he don't waste any time.
Orlando delivers high line drive. Wynn's got it, but center fielder for the Patriots, Taylor, backs up and catches it for out number two.
Out for him.
All right, Mr. Mamadas.
Stay hot, buddy.
Yes, sir.
Matthew
Pomadas. Foul tip, strike one. Orlando's a junior, so we may have to face him again next year some. He is.
Well, that'd be all right. Listen, Pomadas 3-for-3 on the day, Scott.
That's right.
Swinging a hot bat.
Called strike. Mamata steps out, takes his time. Umpire holds off Mr. Orlando. Orlando gets ready to deliver. High fly ball to the second baseman, takes it for out number three, and that'll do us for the eighth inning as we go to the top of the ninth. The Hurricanes are three outs away from a W here on the Surge Sports Network.
I don't have our season stats in there.
A.J. Willie Mays Hayes steps in here, hopefully to finish this game off rather quickly, get a save opportunity. Will Hardy, leadoff batter, leads off this inning for him. Called strike one.
So A.J. working quick too. Scott? A.J. Willie Mays Hayes.
Uh-oh,
that's a
trouble.
Long run over
that's
there.
Trouble. Stand up double for the leadoff batter. Three-run lead.
That's all right. Hayes coming in doing what he's supposed to do.
That's right. Number 40, Kemp, steps in there. Brett Kemp.
And I believe, is that Harrison Timberlake in the bullpen?
So we got the top of the lineup starting this inning. Hayes delivers strike one, 0-1 to Kemp.
Right fielder Brett Kemp.
Scott, Keith Mickley still working so hard. He's throwing papers in front of me left and right.
McLeague, the miracle worker.
He is. So, Hayes, he came into today's game with a 4.97 ERA. 38 innings pitched. And I don't believe Hayes does have two saves already on the year, working on his third as there's a fly ball to Skelton as he records out
one.
Number one.
Gage Taylor, center fielder, number 10, steps in there. He made a good play last inning to Rob. I forgot who hit that one deep.
One out. Batters the center fielder, Gage Taylor.
I can't remember, Scott. I was in deep thought.
Well, right, we need our intern.
Should ask you, Breaker.
Shabrika is doing a good job working the cameras. She can't keep up with our shenanigans. Ball skips in there to Harold. Harold blocks it. Keeps the runner at second. Umpire going to walk out there and let Harold recover.
You know, as Tucker Smith, our starter of this game, we failed to mention, he does lead the Peach Belt in innings pitched. Coming into this game, he had thrown 92 innings pitched, four complete games, 75 strikeouts, seven wins. And, you know, he's first in strikeouts, first in complete games, first in innings pitched.
And he's tied for second in wins.
Yeah, so Tucker Smith.
He's the pitcher on record in this game.
And we have some other Hurricanes in here with tied for second was Bo Halcom with four triples. Tied for second, guess who, in ERA?
That would be Tucker Smith.
Tucker Smith came into today's game with a 2.25 ERA.
Ball four. Runners at first and second, one out. Number 42, Nick Pappas, steps in there, face Hayes. Pappas, the tie and run.
One out at the plate, first baseman Nick Pappas.
Hayes, just get us a ground ball right here. Roll a double play for us. Get us out of here with a win for game one.
Francis Marion's had a pretty good season. Their record 24-17. They're 14-12 in the Peach Belt Conference.
Yeah, this cat's been hot. He's 3-for-3 at the plate today, Scott. Pappas has been very difficult to get out.
Pappas, a junior, from Columbia, South Carolina, hails from Dutch Fork High School. I wonder what Dutch Fork High School, I wonder what their mascot is. I tell you what, it's not. Syrup makers. Because there's only one of those that I'm aware of.
And you went down there to get a shirt and came back empty-handed.
I did. I got to wait till the fall because I didn't like their selection. So I'm gonna. They said come back in the fall, they'll have a whole new shipment in. So I can wait. I've waited this long for one. I can wait just a few more months. But if anybody in Cairo has an extra T-shirt they ain't using. So we've walked the bases loaded. This is Lenny Gonzalez, switch hitting power hitter.
Coach Matt Lamothe's going to come out and have a word with A.J. Hayes. And as Coach Lamothe makes his way to the mound, we'll take a short break. You're listening to the Surge Sports Network.
Lenny Gonzalez, switch hitting power hitter, steps in there, taps a plate after the visit from Lamothe. Hayes gets ready to deliver. Ball outside.
And Gonzalez is 0 for 3 on for today.
Lord, let him be 0 for 4 and hit into a double play in the top of the ninth inning.
That would be very, very nice.
Strike. I went ahead and called that one because I knew it was. 1-1.
I believe we've only walked six. It feels like a lot more than
that. Harrison Timberlake is warming up in the bullpen for the Hurricanes. Good curveball there, Scott.
1-2. Kind of handcuffed him a little bit.
I think he may see another one of those. He just needs to make sure he stays on top of that curveball and does not hang it.
I bet he's wishing he didn't take that strike right down the middle because he's going to get low and inside the rest of the time, I believe, don't you?
I hope he sees that same pitch right there.
Lenny Gonzalez, designated hitter, steps in there. Hayes gets ready to deliver with the bases loaded, one out. He got around that one a little better. I think this is where I go my knuckle slurve.
Looks like Hayes missed his spot a little bit right there. I can't see the camera, but I knew Harrell was set up outside. That may have been kind of closer to down the middle. So a big situation here for both teams, Scott. Bases loaded for Francis Marion. Canes just need two outs to win this ball game.
High fly ball. Bo Halcombe underneath it. Comes up, catches it, comes up firing, holds the runner at third. Skelt gets down on it, cuts it off. I am glad to see Mr. Gonzalez going back to the dugout.
I am too, Scott. Skelton told me before the game he was sore. He said he didn't know what he was sore from, but he's going to be even sore after today because he's already been hit by a pitch. He's gobbled up a couple over there, and that right there just hit him in the chest.
Catcher Alex Griffin.
Skelton is not old enough to be sore, not know where it comes from. I mean, you know, you get our age, you know, a lot of our injuries are sleep related.
Well, let me tell you, with his mentality too, he don't give a crap.
I'm sure. Alex Griffith, catcher in there. If they're going to take strike one, we're going to take it from them. We're going to give it to them.
So we'll take anything right now.
That's right. So 0-1.
Any base. Two outs.
Hayes gets ready to deliver. Griffith. Low, 1-1. One ball, one strike. A.J. Hayes deliver. Top of the ninth inning. Two outs. Bases juiced.
Dale Griffith.
Alex.
Oh, Alex. Yeah. Uh-oh. Jamar's got to get on his horse.
And does. That's it for out number three. Canes win. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Enjoy this one on the Surge Sports Network. We got another game coming up. You'll have to tune in to you'll have to refresh it because it won't be on the same channel. I mean, it'll be on the same channel, but they're going to have to stop this game and start another one. Is that
that's
what Mick Lick said?
I think that's right.
All right. See y'all in a bit, y'all.
Come back to see us.